Hudsonville.
And WDTL HD2 Baton Rouge.
This hour brought to you by Spencer Callahan Injury Lawyers.
LA 21-12682.
Offices in Baton Rouge.
The biggest names in sports are on ESPN Radio.
Spent the whole last segment talking about how awesome Jimmy Johnson is. Now you're here.
As a kid, watching Jim Nabors singing Back Home Again in Indiana, I would get the goosebumps. I'm not even from Indiana.
Gary Payton, Hall of Fame point guard.
For my son, showing kids, it's not a big deal to have a disability. Just work through it and become the person you're going to become.
UConn women's basketball superstar Paige Beckers.
A couple years ago, this whole NIL thing didn't really exist. Doing it while inspiring the next generation of basketball players is awesome.
Three-time NBA champion Sean Livingston.
At the end of the day, we're all people. We play a game, but we're all dealing with real life, not just on the court, but off the court as well.
Cooper Kupp, Super Bowl MVP. I have to ask you about the McVay wedding.
The moment that stole the show was Sean and Veronica on stage singing California Love. After that happened, I told them, I was like, okay, well, we can go now.
When it comes to talking sports, we'll be all you ever need. 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Good morning, everybody. It is 7 a.m. on Thursday, June 23rd. Your government taco forecast today in Baton Rouge expects sunny skies with a high of 99. Government taco, where our pickled onions always make a taco wet. Coming up on OTB, the SEC Network's Peter Burns joins the show at 7:15. We talk to Connor O'Gara of Saturday Down South at 8 o'clock, and LSU running back John Emery joins the show at 9:15. Hour number one of Off the Bench, live from the Mercedes-Benz Baton Rouge studio, starts now.
Let him go!
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Jacob Hester and T-Bob Hebert.
Yeah!
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Hey, they said I gotta come off the bench.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. Yo.
Yo, and welcome in to Off the Bench here on a Thursday morning. Jacob Hester, no vacationing. Yes. Again, T-Bob is on vacation, but that's okay. Cody Worsham's good enough to sit in for a full hour with us to fill in for. I don't know how it happened.
Is it like 4 weeks? Is it PTO accumulation? Like, how does this work?
I need to renegotiate my deal at LSU.
Apparently.
It does roll over.
Okay.
And I guess he didn't take vacation in the past 4 years leading into 2022. But yes, he's on vacation.
Hold on, time out. COVID. We were all at home. We were out of the office. We all accumulated a ton of vacation. That doesn't really count.
That's true.
I guess he's just spinning through it all right now.
Oh, he keeps telling me, and the boys can back me up. Mario, Danny will get. But he keeps like saying like, this is it. This is the final one. And it's still going on right now. And he's like, there might be a day in August as well.
Can we air some dirty laundry?
Yeah.
Is this T-Bob or is this T-Bob's wife pushing the vacation?
Where
are they? Is this a Star Wars themed trip? Because if it is, then I know it's T-Bob. But if it's not, then
okay,
you never know.
Well, so they went to Disneyland out in Cali, and you know, girls are pretty young. I don't know if they're gonna remember the trip, so that might be on T-Bob.
That's this one for sure.
Caitlin was actually working in New York, and T-Bob's like, I want to bring the girls to the city.
Ah.
So they're going to New York Thursday, Friday,
okay,
Saturday.
I was just there. I would have stayed if I didn't know T-Bob
was coming.
I met him at the top of the One World Observatory. It'd been great.
Are you committing to standing?
I guess so. It's a new feel here on Off the Bench. I've been watching, obviously, daily, every day.
Thank you.
From start to finish. I never miss a second.
Subscribe and like.
Yep. And I've noticed that y'all been standing. And so I walked in. I was like, is this a standing thing now? And you kind of had a limp going. So I thought maybe... with the soreness that you developed, that this was going to be a sitting day, but apparently it's a standing day. So really, I just don't know what to do with my hands. So I'll probably grab my phone and like pretend to look at it, even though there's nothing going on my phone. Yeah, I'll stand.
Yeah.
I'll commit.
So as I was telling you, I started to work my boys out for football training. We started that on Monday. And I mean, ladders and parachutes and cone drills, the whole deal. And on Tuesday, I noticed someone was moving in our neighborhood and I see him and I'm like, man, that person looks familiar. Ended up being Jake Flint, LSU strength and conditioning head coach. And I'm wondering, it's either two things. He was either like, okay, Hess, I see you working the kids out. Or he's like, ooh, you really lost it, Hess.
I think I think it's probably the former. Like, if I saw someone out in public, like, podcasting, I'd, like, watch that and be like, yeah, that's cool. I like that. I like that this is a thing that's growing in our community. So he was just admiring that his professional work was being displayed in the community.
Yeah, and not a washed-up 37-year-old is out there doing
I bet you could still go.
Parachutes.
I bet you could still move.
Parachute's okay. Ladder drills, it's a little slower than it used to be. It's not as smooth.
I'm back at beach volleyball this week, the last couple weeks. It's amazing how much you age at this age, like
rapidly.
The aging that takes place over 6 months when you're in your mid-30s is much different than the aging that takes place over 6 months in your mid-20s. It's just a different ball game. So it's been rough. Hopefully, Kristen Nuss and Taryn Cloth are coming out there and watching me play beach volleyball. Good Lord,
that's kind of that's the equivalent of what it would be like.
Yeah, they don't. Need all to right, see that. No one really
let's go to two people that don't have that problem yet, but they will in the near future. For Mario, not so near future for Danny. A little bit older there, Mario. Fellas, how you doing this morning?
Doing well, man. Feel amazing. Slept great last night. Okay. NBA draft day today. Gonna be a good day. Gonna be a good weekend.
All right. Love the positive vibes, Danny.
Feel great. Ready for the Pelicans draft tonight, and hopefully they get a stud.
I hope they do, too. And can y'all back me up that T-Bob has said multiple times, this is the last one for vacation days?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
And June, man.
On this one, I think it was either Saturday or Sunday night. Now, I mean, a couple of days ahead of time, but he's just like, going to be out again, boys.
Like a couple of days heads up. No 2 week notice policy here, guarantee. So no. I can one up that. So you asked me to come on yesterday. I agreed to it. Mm-hmm. Just got back in town from New York, so didn't have a ton of time with the wife. I was like, I'm not going to ask my wife now. It's like, I'm going to ask her tonight.
Yeah.
Well, she fell asleep early. I didn't ask her. So, and then she woke up in the middle of the night, didn't get good sleep. So I probably told her about 20 minutes ago. So when I get home, it's waiting for me.
So
we'll be okay.
You owe her and I owe her.
Yeah, I was just letting you know that I'm driving up the price now.
What can I do to make this better? Because I know that feeling. It's not great. Like, if you give your boys a couple days heads up, whatever. Like, you know, I asked you yesterday and you're like, yeah, you can't do that at home.
Nope. It's going to come back to get me. I got to get better at that. So that's on me. I'll take that one. I'll own that one, and I'll deal with the consequences.
Speaking of the NBA draft, by the way, Tari Eason, obviously going to be someone that gets selected in the first round. At least that's what we assume. Where do you think he goes?
I mean, lottery probably.
Yeah.
From what I've heard, the Spurs love him. So that could be
Feels like a Spurs player.
That could be a landing spot. I think teams are going to fall in love with his skill set, especially in the modern NBA. Like, when you watch the test that I always – I borrow this from Bill Simmons. The test I always use for draft stuff is like, all right, if we were in the NBA finals, would I trust this guy on the floor?
Yeah.
And Tari's not quite there yet with the skill set, with the ball handling, with the shooting. It's pretty close there. But with the athleticism and the two-way ability to guard on one end and be an offensive threat on the other, I think he's there. So I think a team will fall in love with that skill set and think they can develop the other tools, because he's got the tools that you can't develop. He's got the motor. I think teams love his motor, his competitiveness. He hates losing as much as anyone that's come through that program. He hates losing. And just you combine that all with the skill set, and there's a team that'll see, hey, we can get him in and develop him and make him a starter for us. So I would think lottery, top 15. Where are the Spurs at? You guys know better than me. I think they're are they 12-ish?
Yeah, I think they're right after the Pelicans, right? I think they're number 9.
Okay, so they're even higher than that. So that would be the highest he would go. I mean, the lowest is probably right around 20. So we'll see. But it's a big day for him, big day for LSU basketball. Anytime you guys – it's funny. Like, I grew up, there weren't a ton of LSU guys in the NBA. Yeah, I mean, obviously Shaq on the front end, but in that gap between, like, Shaq and, you know, Stromile, there wasn't a ton there. So – now you look up and there's guys everywhere. There's Skylar Mays who voiced over our NBA draft hype video. There's Cam, obviously, last year getting drafted in the lottery or in the first round. You look up and there's just LSU players everywhere.
I mean, Ben Simmons.
Oh, yeah, he did play at LSU, didn't he?
Yeah.
My guy. He still blocks me on Twitter, unfortunately.
Block?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
This is from
I was at Tiger Rag in the media. And maybe I tweeted something critical of his defensive effort during a game at some point. And he blocked me. So, Ben, if you're listening this morning, I know you are. You can unblock me. I'm a fan. I'm a Ben Simmons believer. I'm buying stock in Ben Simmons. It's at a low right now. Yeah. I think it's coming back.
I don't
popular
think,
take.
Like, you don't have to say anything to this. I don't think you're ever going to see him on campus again where you have to, like, defend yourself. So,
I mean, maybe. You never know. We hold out hope. He's a former. Hey,
he is. Once a tiger, always a tiger.
Forever LSU.
There's no question. I understand that.
He'll be back. In the NBA, on campus.
I thought he was probably on campus. Probably not. Tell me everything. If I'm not mistaken, also LSU, Sharif O'Neal is in the draft.
Sharif and Darius, that's the other two that have a chance to get picked. Darius, you know, maybe in that late second round. Sharif's had a ton of workouts. Yeah. Look, if he gets drafted, I think we'd all be surprised. Mm-hmm. But there's a skill set there with the 6'10 and the ability to shoot and the length. He'll definitely be a G League guy, whether or not he gets drafted. If he gets taken in the second round, he'll be, you know, a guy that plays in the G League probably. But it's just good to see those guys getting the workouts, getting the reps, have an opportunity to represent LSU at the next level.
It is very, very – it'd be very difficult not to root for Darius Days. Darius Days is just somebody that gave you his all. He stayed the course. He stayed all 4 years. He gave you some great moments. I do think there is a place for him on an NBA team. I'm not saying he's going to be a star. I'm not saying he's going to be a starter. But I do think a guy like Darius Days with his skill set – we've seen how good LSU was with him, and when they, you know, without him, they just weren't the same team over the last couple of seasons. I do think there's a future for him. Again, I don't know what that role is. It might be down the bench, but I do think he'll play in the NBA and do it for multiple years.
He had a great G League combine. The scouts were very impressed with him. Obviously, he can shoot the ball. He's going to make money playing basketball. Now, is it going to be in the NBA for 10 years? I don't know. With him and Sharif, that's probably not the future. I wouldn't put the money there if I were a gambling man. But you're right. There is a skill set there, and there's a fit, especially in the modern NBA, for that swing big man that can step out and shoot it. I think with Darius, it's just the high-level athleticism that's not quite there with some of the other guys. But he's going to make money playing basketball. Like if he goes to Europe and ends up in Europe, he's going to make a lot of money there. So and he'll have a chance. He'll probably, with the way that the G League is structured now, you have that opportunity to kind of hang around and be, you know, a Gary Payton Jr. type of player that kind of bounces in and out of the league, and then you finally find the right fit, the right place. And then you're a key contributor to an NBA title team. So that, you know,
I mean, Garrett Temple was kind of like that.
Yeah, for sure.
Bounced around a little bit and then found kind of a landing spot.
It's about getting your foot in the door and finding the right fit, right? Because once you find that right fit and show that, hey, you know, you plug in a Darius who, again, doesn't have that high-level athleticism, but you put him around four other athletes, and all he has to do is step out and knock down shots and rebound, which we know he can do, and be competitive on both ends of the floor, he can do that. He can play that role. I always compared him to Grant Williams. He didn't quite have the Grant Williams' career. Grant was SEC Player of the Year maybe in 18-19 him and Tremont were kind of the front runners there. I always thought he would transition into that type of player, and he didn't quite hit that ceiling, but just a really solid, steady contributor for LSU over 4 years. And he'll get a look. He'll get a shot.
Yeah, I think so as well. Again, we'll have more coverage. Mario's going to help us out there about 8:30 on today's show. We'll do a deep dive into the NBA draft. We're going to take a break now. When we come back, we're going to go to Omaha. Peter Burns of the SEC Network and SiriusXM is live in Omaha. We had a game that had a save situation last night in the nightcap. We'll recap all of the action there in Omaha with Peter Burns when we come back here on Off the Bench.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
All right, go to allstartoyotaofbatonrouge.com, allstartoyotaofbatonrouge.com. We tell you every single day, if you're buying, if you're leasing, if you're renting, they are the place to go. Now, certainly if you're buying a new vehicle, the full fleet is available. But also, like, when you're leasing a vehicle, when you're renting a vehicle, it's just not the case everywhere. You're going to go in and maybe you want to get a rental, and they've got like three options. The full fleet is available over at All-Star. So if you need a full-size SUV, Sequoia, they've got you covered. If you need a Highlander, that mid-size SUV, that's what we drive around town, they've got you. If you need a truck, they got the Tundra, they have the Tacoma, they have multiple hybrids, they have it all, even the Sienna minivan. So if you've got a summer vacation coming up, if you've got a tournament that you're driving to, maybe you got an extra passenger, you know you got the sports equipment in the back, and your vehicle currently right now isn't big enough. It's per-day pricing. It's fantastic per-day pricing. You can find it on the homepage of the website, allstartoyotaofbatonrouge.com. Again, visit the homepage, allstartoyotaofbatonrouge.com.
In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
Bayou Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram has new 2021 Jeep Wranglers and Jeep Gladiators on our lot now with $5,000 off MSRP. And all new Bayou vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. If you need sales or service, the crew at Bayou is going to do right by you.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs.
For a Thursday edition of Early Line, as we start looking ahead to the weekend's action and recap last night's games from Omaha and the College World Series. Plus, we look ahead to the NBA draft. Join us 2 to 3 p.m. 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Bring it.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob, the 2022 LAB Prestige Award winner for Best Sports Radio Show, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
All right, welcome back in, OTB. Going to go to the phone lines now. Going to go to Omaha now, where our good friend Peter Burns, SEC Network, Sirius XM, joins us now. PB, what's up, man? How you doing?
What's up, boys? I thought you were going to say I was getting jiggy with it. And I'm like, it's just, it's 7:17 in the morning. I'm not quite there.
I don't know.
We may or may.
You live in East Coast. You live on East Coast time. It's 8:17 body time.
Oh, no, trust me. Listen, and when you got kids, as you know, you got two kids under five. Like, if you ever get a chance to sleep in past, I don't know, 6:15, life is gravy. But we may or may not have run into a bunch of Arkansas fans last night. And, It was a late night, boys. We're pushing through this morning, doing the Lord's work.
Peter, are you saying that you contributed to the Jello Shot Challenge tally? Is that what you're saying?
All I know is that at one point I ordered like a salad at like 3:15 a.m. And I'm like, what am I? I was not making great life choices, boys. I did not adult well last night. I'm not going to lie. I'm going to be a straight shooter with you.
It's like literally the opposite of getting jiggy with it, is ordering a salad at 3:15 in the morning.
Yeah, like that's when you go burger fries.
Yeah, I feel like that was the responsible there I was after probably consuming 9,000 calories of Jell-O shots and drinks that I'm like, instead of the burger and fries, let me be a responsible adult now and downshift to the Caesar salad. So, yeah, it was and it was out of a vending machine too. So,
Wait.
Yeah.
Hold up.
Yeah.
The hell is salad out of a vending machine? Walk me through this.
So in the hotel lobby, Oklahoma and Notre Dame are staying in that hotel, and they have like they just have so many people here in Omaha that I guess Hilton has one of these things where it's like, hey, if you want a snack on the go or something, our chefs prepare meals. And I'm like, that's a no for me. That's a no for me, dog. I'm never going to do that. And then at 3:15 in the morning when nothing really is open, you're like, I mean, why would I not pay $9 for salad of a vending machine? So it was a little bit of a look of shame this morning when I woke up and looked over on the side. So good morning.
Yeah, I mean, good morning. That I've never heard of a salad in a vending machine. Leave it to Peter Burns to introduce it to me. So that's well done. Hey, before we get to the baseball, you're an SEC man. Now, obviously, you're an LSU guy, but since the Tigers aren't in Omaha, if you got a Jell-O shot, whose tally did you tell them to add it to, Arkansas or Ole Miss?
I actually put it to A&M as a thanks for being here. Just kind of like pouring out a shot for them. So, yeah, it's actually, I mean, it's crazy. I mean, it was a brilliant marketing ploy Rocco's did. And at some point, though, we kept talking about it. I'm like, all right, they're making so much money on this thing, but I'm not quite sure if you guys have talked about the update. The owners came through and said, listen, you know, so many small businesses like in Baton Rouge and other places, they're struggling through the pandemic. So they said, this is, you know, we're a locally owned company. Thank you for helping out. And then they donated half of every single shot proceeds to two food banks.
Oh, wow.
And I thought that was pretty cool. One in Fayetteville and one in Oxford. So I thought that was a really cool thing.
Oh, absolutely. Good on them. That is fantastic. We'll have to look that story up and make sure that we highlight it later on in the show. All right, PB. Hey, we finally had a close baseball game. We had a save situation in Omaha. Didn't think we were going to get that. There was finally the drama last night in the nightcap that we were waiting on. I mean, we're watching Oklahoma take care of A&M 5-1. It's like, okay, well, at least it was almost a save situation. I mean, it was a four-run game. That's the closest that we had had. It was a four-run game. But last night, I think all that drama finally built up, and we actually saw what we're used to seeing in Omaha, which is a close game, tight in the ninth.
Yeah, we always do our show for SEC Network, right, in left field, and we don't go on until the final out, right? So, and every single year, there's at least 50 to 65% of the games that we're like, I don't know what guess we're going to have. I don't know what our notes are going to look like because the game is still in, you know, in question. And what, last night was the 12th game that we've had in Omaha and the first time that we've had one within four. But, yeah, I mean, listen, you know, Arkansas, I felt, had the advantage going in just because of, you know, Ole Miss was going to pitch this kid named John Gaddis, who hadn't pitched a lot, but he actually pitched pretty well. But, you know, Arkansas had that insurance run in the eighth, which was monster, because if they don't get that, who knows what happens, because Ole Miss started putting that rally together. And then when they had bases juiced, nobody out, 2-0 count, we're like, holy hell, Ole Miss is about to punch their ticket. And, you know, Zach Morris came in, the AKA Saved by the Bell joke there, and, yep, and got him out, and now we got a monster game, which they may run out. I mean, they may run out of alcohol in Omaha because last night was out of control. And with a trip to the College World Series on the line between some,
and that is what happens when you get a salad from a vending machine.
Yeah,
your cell phone connection just
yeah, you lose. Now it was struggling. It was struggling. It was struggling. But
oh. Oh, did you guys lose me?
We got you now.
Sorry, I'm in the middle of nowhere. I'm almost to Nebraska City, Nebraska, and I guess cell phone coverage isn't great. Yeah, so
I hadn't made it there yet. It's okay. You'll get there eventually. Look, when you have a salad out of a vending machine 4 hours ago, what do you expect with the cell service, Peter? We're not mad at you.
Yeah, I know. It's just my life. But, no, it was – listen, man. It, like I was saying, it was 25,000. They were on their feet for almost the entire game, and it's going to be nuts tonight for sure.
Now, I'm looking forward to it. And look, I'm just looking forward to some drama. That's what we want in Omaha. Now, Oklahoma's sitting there, and they're just waiting on the opponent. And what an awkward situation it is probably for the Big 12. You've got Oklahoma dominates in softball, maybe the best team that we've ever seen. And here they are in baseball. They're in the final. Now, you're going to claim it. They're in the Big 12 now, but you know that, you know, in a couple of years, maybe even sooner rather than later, they're going to be in the conference that we cover mostly, the SEC. And so it's just an awkward situation. That's the best way I can describe it, is high school awkwardness, Peter.
Yeah, I mean, it is very, like, sophomore dance type stuff. Yes. But, I mean, you know, you're trying to figure out what do you do. I mean, if you're the Big 12, Oklahoma obviously having a lot of success. Texas is such a big brand that you still want them to a certain extent. But my thoughts is, and this is on no inside information, but my thoughts is that they'll enter the SEC in 2024. I still think they'll come at least a year early, or maybe try to come even 1 year prior to that if they get a brand new Big 12 commissioner and they're like, hey, let's just have a clean break. So, I mean, this is going to be such a murderer's row of baseball. It would not shock me if 1 year we have six or seven teams from the SEC here. And I don't necessarily know if that's great for the game of college baseball, but the hell with that. I'm selfish, and it's great for me at the network. So the hell with it.
I was about to say, I know you, Peter Burns, and I know that is great for you. All right, before we let you go, I saw that you finally made your NFT. You were the last person to actually do it for the Players Lounge. So shout out to, you know, procrastination and you finally getting it done. Hey, but you look good in it. I saw the suit. I saw the mohawk. I could tell that was something that you wanted to rock for a long time. Just Lauren would not approve of it. So you did your job. We'll show it a little bit later on in the show. We'll get it thrown up there. But congratulations for finally doing what you were supposed to do.
This thing is so cool, too. And I'm so upset that I can't be there at the launch party, because this thing is like, I've actually had people here in Omaha ask me about, like, all right, what's the project? What have you guys been doing? And again, like, while I was talking to some of the ADs, they're like, you know, they understand that NIL comes in so many different forms. And these are the type projects with the Players Lounge that they want to have. They want guys that have done really well on campus to be rewarded. And this, like, projects like this is exactly why NIL came together, and really important for recruiting when it comes to, hey, this is what we've done for our student athletes. So it's a really cool project. And I do like the avatar I got this week.
All right, PB, I wish you could go get some sleep, but I'm sure you're working like 17 other shows you've got going on. So eventually when you get an opportunity, go get some sleep. But until then, thanks for hopping on with us.
I never sleep, because sleep is a cousin of death. Later, boys.
Okay, that sounds like Joey Hester. That's exactly what that sounded like there. I will not get past a couple of parts of that. The baseball talk is great, and Peter does a fantastic job. Let's get to the nitty-gritty, though, the stuff we care about.
The salad.
You get a salad out of a vending machine. Questionable, but even more questionable. And I know that when he said that, we had one person in this studio that was judging him harder than anyone, and that is Mario. Mario is the biggest, and I mean biggest, cheeseburger fan that you've ever met in your life. And it was a perfect opportunity, Mario, for Peter Burns at 3 a.m. to get a cheeseburger, and he went salad. How'd that make you feel?
Oh, man, that's terrible. Waste of resources at 3 a.m. for sure.
So I've seen these vending machines. We were at Disney in the spring with the kids, and obviously Disney, they're going to figure out a way to sell whatever they can sell to you. And so they had a vending machine full of, like, fresh-ish food in the lobby, but I was very dubious, very dubious and skeptical. Now, of all the choices, like, there's cheeseburgers, there's hot dogs, there's, like, your standard, like, concession stand fare.
Yeah.
I mean, we're going with a salad?
Yeah.
Like, that's concerning. I'm concerned for Peter's health today. Yeah. I think that's actually the less healthy choice.
I agree.
It may
you.
Have been, like, better, like, in terms of macronutrients.
Yes.
But what was in that salad? What was really in that salad to keep it sustained?
To keep that
fresh?
Lettuce green.
I mean, how long was it in there for? That's there's some real questions, and I'm concerned about.
Yeah, and, dude, who doesn't go full fat boy at 3 a.m.?
You got to.
I mean, there's a reason why Whataburger and places like that thrive. Yes. It's where you go get stuff done after midnight. Yeah. Like,
the salad bar isn't open at 2:30 in the morning, right? Like, you're not walking into the grocery store with a salad bar at like 2:30 in the morning. It's a bad decision. It's
our case, rest, Your Honor. That's all. That's it. That's all you have to say. All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll talk with Cody about LSU Gold, the new streaming service. We caught up with Emily Dixon a couple of weeks ago. Want to talk some of that with Cody when we come back here on OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Join 100.7 The Tiger and Our Lady of the Lake Ascension Saturday, June 25th at the Lamar Dixon Expo Center in Gonzales.
Enjoy live music from Tet Dur, Mike Broussard and the Night Train, and Jamie Badron and the Kickin' Cajuns. Make sure you grab a delicious plate of jambalaya from the Mike Ward's Liberty Safe's Jambalaya Cook-Off to raise money for the Alzheimer's services of the capital area.
The Swamp Pop Music Festival with Supreme Chevrolet.
Louisiana's Country Station.
100.7 The Tiger.
There it is, the extra mile, on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected, supported by a five-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the one-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded, because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
It's no secret, the best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who are born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
Skona inviting you to join us for Thursday's AFR presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. I'm out. Leah Van of The Advocate will be here talking LSU baseball roster and previewing the NBA draft. 3-6, 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
All right, welcome back in. OTB here on a Thursday morning. Cody Worsham sitting in for a couple more.
Yes.
And I do have to give him credit. So as y'all know, we've been for over the last, what was it, Mario, 5 weeks?
Yeah, like 6 weeks.
Five, 6 weeks. We've been doing 25 or 30, depending on how you're feeling, push-ups in between each segment. You know, trying to get the blood flowing. You don't want to be sitting around for 3 hours. We also stand. So Cody is standing with us. He's not complaining about the chair like some people do in this studio. And he's also doing the push-ups. So now Mario's doing the push-ups. I'm doing the push-ups. Our guest Cody Worsham's doing the push-ups.
Sorry, Danny.
Young Danny is not.
Didn't mean to put you on the spot there.
I just don't understand it because he's like the most muscular of any of us in here.
He's a principled man. I respect it. Once you take that stance, you stick with it. I respect that. I'll say this. What amazed me most about it was just how naturally y'all got into it. Like, it's not a natural thing to do, but, like, y'all just carried on your conversations and, like got down in the push-up position and just kept talking while you were – that was the impressive part. Like, I had to, like, step aside, take a breath, gather myself, do my push-up. You know, y'all just – I've got it. I've got it down now.
I mean, my chest is probably looking a lot swollen than it was 6 weeks ago, but I honestly just do it for the feeling. Like Hester said, it gets your blood pumping. I kind of feel better for the rest of the day, especially this early in the morning.
For sure. Who needs coffee? Just do a few push-ups.
Well, you can do both. I mean,
yeah.
Let's don't talk crazy talk here. chill out. I have my cup, and then this bad boy is full as well.
Yeah,
so
that's a big one. It's a large cup.
I got a refill, so let me just go ahead and leave that up there. Like, it's just at home. If you're watching us on YouTube, if you're listening to us, don't do it in your car. Could be dangerous there. Hit 25 push-ups.
I mean, it'd be impressive if you could do it while driving.
That'd
I don't know how
impressive. Yeah, like don't Teslas drive themselves or something? I wouldn't know. I have a 12-passenger van. So.
I'm not quite in the market for a Tesla. It's not quite the vehicle that I'm
on. Yeah, I've got 97 children, so I'm not either. All right, I want to talk about LSU Gold, the new streaming service LSU released a couple of weeks ago. We had Emily Dixon on the show to talk about it, but now that it's kind of been living, breathing for a couple of weeks, maybe give a little update on what fans can expect and when they can expect it.
Yeah, so August 1 it launches. It's going to be – the way that I describe Gold is it's a whole new content arm of LSU Athletics. So if it's been free before, it's still free. Like, we're not taking anything that's existing and putting it behind a paywall. That's not the goal of Gold. The goal was to do something new and bigger and better. And so the example that I always use is Joe Burrow in 2019. So in 2019, Matt Tornquist at LSU walks in my office in the right before the bye week, says, "Hey, what are you doing for the bye week?" I'm like, "Well, I'm resting because it's been a crazy season
so
far."
Oh my God.
He's like, "Do you want to go to Athens, Ohio?" And I was like, "Oh Lord." So you know what, Matt, if you want to go, I'll go. So we go to Athens, Ohio. Yeah. We interview all Joe's former coaches, his parents. And by the way, all that stuff will be on Gold, like the full interviews of all those things.
Oh, wow. So
we've only released samples of it, pieces of it. But I turned it into an hour and 20-minute podcast episode. And Matt turned it into a 4-part video series. And we loved doing that. But you can only do so much of that with limited resources. Like, we have other things that we have to do. Gold will give us the ability to do so much more of that stuff. And I know that there's skepticism with the price point. It's going to be on us to prove that it's worth it, right? Like, if you sign up for it and you pay for it, it's going to be on us to prove that, hey, this is a valuable time of an investment in my energy. And I think it will be. I know it will be. I got the first screener of the first behind-the-scenes documentary with Coach Kelly. So that's probably the keystone project is a follow documentary that will follow LSU football all season long. Incredible access. I got a sneak peek of the first episode. It entails his hiring, essentially. And look, I've been behind the scenes for a lot of this stuff. There was stuff in there that I didn't know, that I hadn't seen. And by the end of the episode, I was like, take my money. Like, I will pay for it now. And I'm not saying that just to plug it. Obviously, I'm here to plug it. I want it to succeed. I really mean that. It was really, really good. We have a really talented team that Emily's built to do this. So I'm excited just for that, just to see coverage of LSU and behind the scenes content that I've never seen that quality before. Arkansas has done it. Oklahoma State has done it. We're doing it a little bit differently where we're bringing everything in-house and investing in it. And what that does is it gets us a little increased trust. And so the coaches open the doors a little bit more.
That's fair.
And, you know, Arkansas, Oklahoma State, Clemson, they've had success with it. I think we can really take it to the next
level. I guess I didn't even realize. I knew that Arkansas had done it. I maybe knew that Clemson. I didn't know that Oklahoma State. So this is something that y'all felt like probably go ahead and get in front of, since there's a model, people are doing it. Now, obviously, you want to do it different, you want to do it better, you want to do it bigger, all of that. But it's something that, you know, 10 years from now, like, it could be something that almost every major school has.
Yeah, that's the goal. That's the goal, is to be on the front lines of it. Yeah. Playfly, our multimedia rights holder, came to us about a year ago and pitched the idea. And so we've been developing it more deliberately, because we did want to have this larger investment in it, to where it wasn't, you know, there's some other schools that are doing this, maybe you just mentioned some of them, that are basically taking stuff that already exists for free, putting it behind a paywall, maybe adding in a little bit here and there. It's really not that different. From the start, we said, if we're going to do this, we're not going to do it that way. Like, we're really going to put something behind the paywall that people love and care about. And it's not just going to be a followed documentary with football. It'll be basketball, it'll be baseball, it'll be softball, it'll be soccer. We'll be with all those sports embedded with them, telling these stories. And that's what I'm passionate about. I love telling these student athlete stories, getting them out to the public. Look, for me, I think, and this is just me personally, as an Arsenal fan, for example, I pay $12 a month for two Arsenal podcasts, right? It's two kind of premium podcasts. As a fan, I just want a depth of engagement there. And for me, it's worth that money. So that's what we're trying to provide, is depth of engagement. Like, if you can't get enough, if you watch OTB every morning for 3 hours, if you're on the programming all day on 104.5 ESPN, and you're sitting there at the end of the day, you're like, man, I still want to watch some more LSU stuff. Mm-hmm. You'll be able to pull up your Roku, your Apple TV or whatever, and pull up Gold on your OTT platform or on your iPad or whatever, and watch the latest episode and get that extended depth of coverage. And now there's plans to grow it and add more things to it that I think are going to be really cool, beyond the follow documentaries and the podcasts and the exclusive interviews. We have some very big visions for phase two and phase three and all that stuff.
Right.
But you got to get launched first. And so we're launching it and getting it out there. And I think people will really like it. I think especially this, having seen the first episode of the follow documentary series, it was really well done by Emily's team. And I'm excited for the world to see it.
Yeah, I mean, I'd be embarrassed to say how much I pay for Everton material, and they finished.
Hey, they survived. 17th. They survived.
They did survive. By the way,
we've always talked about having a soccer podcast.
Yeah.
There's a space now for, like, if we're on a Monday, we're like, look, let's just talk a little soccer. Why not? We got a space for it now.
Don't tempt me with a good time.
When I first got to LSU, I was like, I would love to have, like, a podcast network within LSU and do more of that. And I know y'all are doing some of that here. I just think it's something for everybody. If you're a podcast person, you want to listen every day to something, we'll have that. If you want to sit down and watch a documentary follow series on LSU football with dinner, that'll be there too. And then we'll build that out even more to do some more cool things.
One of the things that, like, I'll give you an example that I hope will be on the LSU Gold. So we used to do film rooms, and the film room, sometimes it's 30 minutes, but you got to cut it down to 8 minutes. Yep. And that's even long, more like 6 minutes. Some would be 45 minutes. Like, when I had one, I think you were in there with Mike Jones, like, that one went for like an hour. And we sat there and we could have talked all day long, but you have to cut it down to 6 minutes. The one where Flynn and I relived the Florida game in 07, that was how long? I don't even remember.
I think I went for 30 to 40 minutes. And that day, I vividly remember being like, man, I wish people could hear this whole thing. Now you can, because, like, they literally uploaded that one to the platform a couple days ago. And it's really good, because you and Flynn just have that chemistry. That was really good. But, like, Mike, that was an incredible one too. And that was another thing where everything that's been free, right? Like, all the hype videos or the cool videos that Matt does, you know, after a game, before a game, whatever, that represents about 1% of what we shoot, right? This now gives us a space for the other 99% to go in there. And it's there's some incredible stuff in there. Like, the first episode had Coach Kelly's first talk to the team when he got hired. And I know we put a little bit of it out on social media, but there was more to it than what was on social media. And I saw it for the first time when I was screening this thing, and I was goosebumps, like, ready to run through a wall, like, when is football season here? And that's the kind of stuff that I think will prove the value, hopefully. Like, if you really want to engage deeper in a way that you never have before, this will give the opportunity for that. And if you don't, like, you don't have to. Like, everything that's been free is going to be free. All the podcasts that we're doing are still free. Like, none of that's going away. It's just another opportunity for people to engage on a deeper level, which I'm excited about, and also just the ability for our team and Emily's team to have cameras everywhere and to be filming everything and telling stories about everything is really cool.
Yeah, they got some great stuff in the works, some that I've heard of that I think you'll all be very, very excited about. All right, we're going to take a break. More LSU talk when we come back here on OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
All right, go to iticollege.edu, iticollege.edu. Want to remind you that those fall classes do start on August the 29th, so do not delay. Those spaces are limited. And I also want to remind you that when you work with ITI College, you're working with someone who has been there, who has done that, because these instructors that teach at ITI must have at least 4 years of practical experience in the area that they are teaching. You're also talking about local. You're talking about people that are in this community, right? They spend money in this community. They dine in this community. They do everything in this community. So they're part of the fabric of this community. That's something that is very important to us here on OTB, and I know it is to you as well. They'll help you create that schedule. We talk about that all the time. These class sizes are not some huge packed auditorium. They are smaller classes. You're going to be able to work with your instructor. You're going to be able to understand what you've got going on. Also, remember, they'll give you Fridays off. I mean, it's a no-brainer. iticollege.edu.
In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
And this year, 2022, it's time to finally treat yourself. Bring your boat to the next level with front-to-back boat service. You want the latest and greatest marine technology? You want to go to the place that has not one, but two NMEA certified techs. Family owned and operated by the Sherman family for 30 years, front-to-back is the answer in Baton Rouge for all of your custom boat needs. So head to fronttobackboatservice.com or find them on Facebook, Front to Back Boat Service.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
If you're in an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the Law Office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
Bayou Ford has $10,000 off new Ford F-150s. We have new 2021 F-150s on our lot now with $10,000 off MSRP. And all new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. If you need sales or service, the crew at Bayou is going to do right by you.
Join 100.7 The Tiger and Our Lady of the Lake Ascension Saturday, June 25th at the Lamar Dixon Expo Center in Gonzales.
Enjoy live music from Tet Dur, Mike Broussard and the Night Train, and Jamie Badron and the Kickin' Cajuns. Make sure you grab a delicious plate of jambalaya from the Mike Ward's Liberty Safe's Jambalaya Cook-Off to raise money for the Alzheimer's services of the capital area.
The Swamp Pop Music Festival with Supreme Chevrolet.
Louisiana's Country Station.
100.7 The Tiger.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
Poor boy raised amid turn-of-the-century New Orleans, Louis Armstrong became one of the most recognizable people on Earth. Visit dropbiscuit.com today and check out the trailer to our first original series, Pops, The Louis Armstrong Story, starring Reno Wilson. Subscribe today. All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
All right, welcome back in, OTB. Danny, is that a new graphic, the OTB Summer Nights, or am I just now realizing that?
You're just not realizing
that. Yeah, I've seen that one.
The first day of summer, if I'm not mistaken, was just like 2 days ago.
Yeah, 21st,
technically.
June 21st.
Yeah, my mom's birthday is the 21st. Shout out Nancy. And I think that's always the first day of summer. So you were really calling it OTB Summer during the spring. Just say it.
Look, you're beating up on my guy Danny today, and
T-Bob's not here. Yeah, I feel okay. Like I gotta take the role.
I gotta brag on him a little bit. The graphics packages that y'all have are the best. Like the vibe that y'all have built for this show, the graphics packages, the soundtracks,
unbelievable,
unreal.
Danny's love for the 80s.
You want to come work for LSU?
No, chill out, chill. Don't listen to that.
LSU.gold.
I was talking, so we're going to do a tier list tomorrow, and I was talking to Rivers about it, like giving her a heads up, because she's coming in tomorrow, obviously on Friday, and we're, you know, toying around with an idea that had to do with the 80s, and she's like, you know, that's a great idea. Do you think Mario and Danny would be able to do that? You know, they obviously, they weren't born in the 80s. I go, if there's one decade that Danny can handle,
for sure,
whatever it is, it's the 1980s. Right, Danny? Yeah, I mean, come on.
Yeah, greatest era of all time.
It's one, and then like, you know, like going into diners like in the 60s with great music's like two for me.
For sure.
But like 80s is the 80s.
So in New York City this week, toured MSG and saw a signed Elvis poster and thought of you. Thought it was pretty cool.
You didn't snag it?
No. It was hanging on the wall.
Oh, man.
Like you.
I'm always there for you,
look,
too.
Look, I'll make my wife mad to come help you out, okay, but I ain't making MSG mad.
Okay, you don't want to go to jail.
I draw the line somewhere.
By the way, Elvis movie coming out.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
In the chat,
I'm so
someone asked me, hey, are you going to the Elvis movie? I mean, is Pittsburgh the still city? I mean, come on. I'll be the first person
to know that. I'm excited for you.
Yeah, I will be in attendance tonight.
Who's playing Elvis?
Austin Butler.
Okay.
Austin Butler. Somewhat of an unknown. I mean, he's been in stuff before. There you go.
Oh, he looks the part.
He's going to be in Dune 2. Danny, thought about you when I saw that.
Nice.
So, look. It's going to be like a 2.5-hour movie. I know it's going to be long. There's a lot to fit into that window. But y'all know me. Look, I'm a giant Elvis fan. I have a son named Memphis, for goodness sakes. Why didn't you name him Elvis? There's only one Elvis. That's why I didn't name him Elvis.
So, yeah, that would be sacrilegious.
Chill out. I've been to Graceland maybe 10 or 12 times. I'm pretty excited.
I'm happy for you. So we're talking about great eras, right? And having been in MSG, I was thinking a lot about the 70s basketball. Of course, yesterday we announced the Pistol Pete statue is going up in July.
Absolutely.
And so I think that era for me, like that late 60s, early 70s, especially like walking around and seeing the pictures of like Bill Bradley and all the greats that came through there. And then all the concerts that have been there. Did you know that Billy Joel has played that place like 128 months in a row and like sold out like 100 of them?
Every month
he plays a show at MSG and they all sell out.
So
it's crazy.
I believe that place is magical.
It is.
Now,
it's really cool.
I have switch allegiance. I'm now with the Pelicans because Mario, Danny, T-Bob were on in New Orleans. I'm as proud to be from Louisiana as anyone.
Sure.
So like they weren't a team when I was growing up, so I had to choose a team, and I went to Madison Square Garden. So I went one time when I was young. You know, didn't fall in love like I did the second. The second time I went, it was the night that Melo debuted for the Knicks.
Oh, nice.
And I was like, okay, I am like fully in.
Yeah, it's got similar vibes to Tiger Stadium. This is the comparison that I drew. It's like that older, kind of haunted, historical, traditional.
Yeah.
It's not the most updated and renovated, but you can't imitate it. So I've been to some of the nicer arenas, the Mercedes-Benzes and the Jerry Worlds and all that
stuff. 2019, I felt like we did the stadium tour.
Yeah, for sure. And like they're all beautiful stadiums. Yeah. Don't get me wrong. Love those stadiums. But there's just this like – the word I always use is authenticity. There's just authenticity to Tiger Stadium, to MSG, to these older places that have so much history.
You know, you're somewhere special.
Yeah, you can't fabricate it. You can't replicate it.
I mean, just think of like not only basketball, concerts, the boxing matches.
Yeah, yeah.
Like the old school boxing.
They had the heavyweight trophy in MSG, and it was like Sonny Liston, Cassius Clay.
Man.
Like you just see these names. You're like, oh, my gosh, like the history. They actually have a design. I was like, we should do this at LSU somewhere. It's called MSG 366, and it's one day of the year for the whole year, and something historical that happened in that venue on that day. I mean, it was unbelievable.
You're gonna steal it. I'm probably gonna steal that now as well.
Yeah, y'all could do it across the studio.
Just to let you know. I mean, I do too many shows not to steal content. The best ideas are stolen.
Like July 20th, T-Bob said something completely inappropriate on the radio. July 21st, T-Bob said something completely inappropriate on the radio.
Look, I'm just glad we finally got T-Bob during the school year from 7 to 8. I said, you can't do it.
Yeah.
Children are in the car, 7 to 8. Dial it back. From 9 to 10, it's OT.
That's T-Bob's
hour. You can get a little risque. But from 7 to 8, my man, hey, I know there's four big-headed Hesters that are listening.
All right, warning if there are kids listening. The first time I ever did a show with T-Bob, I was, like, nervous, didn't know T-Bob that well.
Yeah.
He called me a DILF. Like, literally coming into the show. I was like, T-Bob, come on, man. Like, and he was, like, super calm. You know how he is the show. He's, like, preparing, and he was, like, very focused and organized. Like, oh, my perception of T-Bob's way off. He's, like, this very organized, professional guy. And then the microphone came on, and that just went flying out.
So this is, I think it's the best part about T-Bob, but it also at times can be the worst part about T-Bob. T-Bob is going to be T-Bob if he's in this room, if he's in Tiger Stadium, if he's in front of the Pope.
No question.
He's going to be the same person.
No question.
Doesn't matter.
Authenticity, baby.
He is the poster child for that.
Gets it from his father.
That is very fair. That is very fair. So... while he's on his 73rd vacation of 2022, not like in the last year, not like in the last 6 months, just like in the last 3 months probably.
Accumulated it. Those COVID vacation hours accumulated for all of us, and now he's spending it all.
Yeah, so you know, because when he called me going on vacation a couple of weeks ago, and I was actually in Destin, I saw you at the SEC spring meetings working.
That was your vacation?
Yeah. And also getting interviews with like the commissioner of the SEC, Brian Kelly, to send back to our show. Like, he was calling that vacation.
Yeah, that wasn't vacation.
No.
I was there. I didn't see the beach the whole time.
I never vacation. Same.
Yeah.
The only time I saw it was the first night they had that little reception, and I kind of saw it from, like, over the little pier there.
Maybe we're doing it wrong. Maybe T-Bob's the one doing it right.
Yeah, he's on his way to New York, and your wife's mad at you for coming here, and I'm going to be on the radio for 2 more hours here and then 3 more hours over on 84.
I think we all have something to learn from
you. Well, thank you for coming, and hopefully it's not that bad at home. If I need to, like, DoorDash some breakfast to the house, you let me know. I got you.
Do I need to do 25 now on the way out as well?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll hit 25.
The heartbreak segment still has push-ups, Cody.
Okay, sounds good.
All right, that's Cody Warsham. When we come back, Connor O'Gara of Saturday Down South will join us here on OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
All right, go to PatientPlusUC.com, PatientPlusUC.com. They are always a convenience for you in a very inconvenient time. Just what they're going to do, 9 a.m. until 9 p.m. every single day. A little bit lower, Cody. Monday through Sunday, they will be there for you. And remember, you can go to PatientPlusUC.com, and you can schedule that appointment online. So if, like, you know you're going to go in, you want to go ahead and get everything done, you can do that. But obviously, sometimes, like, you just have an emergency, like me and my boys, like, sometimes, like, stitches happen, and so you don't have time maybe to go to the website, and you're just going, like, it's okay. Like, walk-ins welcome, certainly. They're going to be able to get you in and get you out. So whatever you've got coming up, like, if you decide you want to dive off your water slide that your kids are on and you separate your shoulder like some idiots, like, you can go into Patient Plus, and they can fix it for you. You're going to get in. You're going to get out. The facilities are top-notch. You're not going to find better facilities anywhere. Go check out those locations. PatientPlusUC.com. Get in and get better.
Have staked out their place at Ochsner Medical Complex, The Grove, where more than 30 pediatricians and pediatric specialists are all conveniently located under one roof, so you can spend less time driving and more time keeping your kids well.
Dibs!
It's no wonder kids call dibs at The Grove. Ochsner Health Center for Children.
My own people call me an Uncle Tom. I play music. Been wine and dined by royalty. Trying to bring people together, all people, but regardless of all that kind of stuff, I'm still Louis Armstrong.
Here's the man you're waiting for, the king of jazz, Louis Satchmo Armstrong.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
Good morning. It's 8 a.m. on Thursday, June 22nd. Your government taco forecast today. Baton Rouge expects sunny skies with a high of 99. Government taco, where our pickled onions always make a taco wet. Coming up on OTB, we talk to Connor O'Gara of Saturday Down South up next, and LSU running back John Emery joins the show at 9:15. You can follow today's show on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok at OTB_ESPN. Or watch us on YouTube at the 104.5 ESPN channel and subscribe for daily content. Hour number two of Off the Bench, live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge studio, starts now.
Let him go!
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Jacob Hester and T-Bob Hebert.
Yeah!
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Hey, they said I gotta come off the bench.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. Yo, yo, yo.
Yo, welcome in. Hour number two of OTB here on a Thursday morning. No T-Bob Hebert, of course, yes, another vacation. But that's okay, because we're going to go to the phone lines now. My guy Connor O'Gara, Saturday Down South, joins us now. Connor, good morning. Thanks for joining us. My man, it has been far too long since we've had a conversation.
Hester, I think the last time I saw you, were you wearing a green suit in Hoover, or am I just thinking back to like a couple of years ago?
There's probably some truth. I have a go-to green suit that next time you see me is probably going to be a wardrobe choice. So there's a chance that you see me in the green suit again. But yeah, I think that was Hoover. It's probably almost a year ago as we are coming on media days here in what, 3-4 weeks?
It's crazy, man. Like, I feel like the summer's been flying by. I'm ready for it, though. I don't think I can talk anymore about Nick Saban, Jimbo Fisher beef. I think we need some actual, like, good bulletin board material that isn't related to that. You know, discussing that probably every which way. I'm ready for some new content.
I am as well. I felt like the child that was in the middle of a divorce during that, obviously playing for both of those coaches. It was a very awkward time for me, so I was like, ready, let's go ahead and get a new storyline here. Like, one of the storylines that you and I haven't had a chance to really catch up on is you've got two new coaches, and Brian Kelly and Billy Napier are two of the biggest blue bloods, not only in the SEC, but in college football. And I'll be honest with you, like, even like being here, being in Baton Rouge, like, you hear, you know, talk about Brian Kelly, but not even as much as I thought, because college landscape, and we'll get to that, is forever changing and changes every single day. But like normally in a normal year, Connor, we'd be talking about these two coaches taking over two major programs.
It is interesting because I think everybody has made a big deal about Brian Kelly and what he's been doing on the internet, the way that he talks, and it feels like we've dissected that in so many different ways. Whereas with Billy Napier, if you lined up every single SEC coach and just had them speak kind of blindly and we weren't looking at them and we were doing a voice test of sorts, I'm not sure that I'd be able to pick Billy Napier's voice out of a crowd. I mean, that kind of speaks to the quiet confidence that he's had so far. And I think part of that, too, is because he knows his team has some holes. I mean, it does. You don't basically come out and say during the spring, we need players if you're really confident about your team. And that's what Billy Napier did. So, you know, I'm more of the belief that it's a long-term move. I think he's going to have an atypically slow start for a new coach at Florida. And that's kind of partially why there hasn't been this hype and this buildup. And, you know, with LSU, it feels like it's been a bit all over the place. I could see a scenario in which they go 6-6. I can see a scenario in which they go 9-3 and they get back to a New Year's Six Bowl. I think it's going to be a great test of the transfer portal and what Brian Kelly's been able to do to overhaul this roster. But I think it's going to be interesting to see the way that those two interact. Very different personalities, of course, and I'm sure they're going to have very different sort of presence in Atlanta at SEC Media Days.
How is it for you trying to get ready for this season? Because kind of, you know, what you just talked about there, I know for me, like getting ready for LSU, even like on this show, who that's a team that we mostly talk about. Like there's so many new faces. You get 17, 18 people through the transfer portal. And then, you know, hosting over on 84, we talk about every single football team. It's like, man, trying to keep up where people are. Like I've got a notebook, Connor, that, you know, is nothing but transfers and where they ended up. And I know you who covers the SEC on a daily basis, like it's difficult. Like it's different now getting ready for this season. Like no longer can you just go get the magazine and feel like you're ready for the season because there's so many new faces in new places.
It's really hard. I keep having that same issue with the transfers as well, where I'll sit down and I'll look at a roster and I'll be like, oh, I totally forgot this transfer was going to a specific place. Like I think it's Antoine Wells, the kid from James Madison who transferred to South Carolina, a receiver that they're really, really high on, that just had these ridiculously good numbers. And I've realized when talking about all Spencer Rattler's weapons that he has, that I've been leaving him out of the conversation. I'm like, oh, I should probably be talking about it more. But like at Alabama, you know, Tyler Harrell, the receiver from Louisville, comes in averaging 29 yards per catch. I'm thinking to myself, oh, you know what? I should probably be talking about him just as much, if not more, than Jermaine Burton. Like these things that, you know, kind of get lost in the shuffle of what's been a really chaotic spring, I think, with all the different movement that we've seen in the transfer portal. So, yeah, when I do my crystal ball series that comes out at the beginning of August, that's really when I feel like I know a lot more about a specific team or, you know, these coaches at Media Days that'll take the chance to kind of bring up guys that haven't been talked about as much. But, man, it's tough. It's really, really difficult. You definitely cannot just crack open the great Phil Steele magazine and feel like you've got everything totally covered because of the amount of movement. And I think come August, I'll feel a little bit better. But right now, I'm admittedly, I've got some holes in my game, and I think I got to be able to take care of those in the next few weeks.
Connor Guerra, Saturday Down South, is our guest here. Connor, I want to ask you about the SEC East before we get to the West. And we know Georgia is going to be obviously the class of the East. Now, behind them, it gets very, very interesting. You know this. I'm a big fan of what Kentucky's been doing over the last couple of years. They had the year that we were kind of waiting for a year ago. Tennessee surprised us all what they were able to do. I think South Carolina can kind of be in that same vein. Now, when you look at the pecking order of the East, how do you think it plays out behind the Georgia Bulldogs?
I think 2-5 is going to be a mess. I really do. I think there are going to be moments in which we go back and forth. And it'll feel a little bit like what the West was last year, where I used to do that on the podcast every single Sunday. We'd be like, so who's the second best team in the West now? We just don't know. I mean, I think that going into the year, I have most confidence in Tennessee being that. Having said that, I think their defense is in for a step back. I predicted last year that they were going to be the worst defense in the SEC with Tim Banks, year one as the defensive coordinator there, all the talk about how they can't play complementary football with the Josh Heupel offense. And I thought Tim Banks' defense overachieved. And they had some guys in key spots that I probably overlooked And now I look at that situation there and I say, from an offensive standpoint, man, they are a dark horse to be the number one offense in all of college football. I know what Ohio State returns. I know what Alabama returns. But I look at that offense with Hendon Hooker, with Cedric Tillman, with Jabari Small. They have pieces galore that should really work well. And all Josh Heupel does is crank out top 10 offenses. So I think that that makes them kind of a little bit of a different beast. And who knows if that's going to lead to an upset of Georgia in Athens. I think that's certainly on the table. I got to figure out yet if I want to go out and make that prediction. But I think Tennessee deserves to be number two in the pecking order. And I think Kentucky, while there are a lot of things I like, I thought I was going to have to bang the drum for Will Levis coming into this year. And now I find myself wanting to temper expectations a little bit. But I think that all the pieces around him that have kind of changed a little bit from an offensive standpoint have me kind of questioning that if Kentucky can be that number two team. And remember, last year they lost to Tennessee in Lexington. So I don't think it's crazy to say that Tennessee is worthy of being the number two team in the SEC East.
I want to talk about Hendon Hooker. I'm glad you mentioned him there because that's someone that I've been trying to tell everyone about, almost like they didn't watch him play a year ago and they just remember when he was at Virginia Tech. He came into the SEC last year, throws for right at 3,000 yards, 31 touchdowns to 3 interceptions. It's just, I don't think anybody just realizes the type of year that he had a year ago. And while you were talking, I was looking it up, like the current Heisman Trophy odds coming into this football season, like some names ahead of Hendon Hooker. Quinn Ewers, who has not thrown a pass in college yet. Anthony Richardson, who's never been a full-time starter at Florida. JT Daniels, Jackson Dart at Ole Miss. Continue to go down the line. Bo Nix at Oregon has better Heisman odds than Hendon Hooker. It's like, what does Hendon Hooker have to do? I mean, he's tied with Max Johnson for Heisman odds, and he threw 31 touchdowns, 3 interceptions last year in a team that wasn't supposed to be any good.
First of all, I'm trying to get this trademarked. I don't think I'm going to be able to make it work, but I'm still doing what I can. Friends don't let friends bet on preseason Heisman favorites. So the fact that Hendon Hooker
Unless it was Joe Burrow, then you got some really good odds.
And look, I mean, Joe Burrow wasn't even a favorite coming into 2019.
No.
So that checks off. So look, I think that Hendon Hooker, for those who didn't watch necessarily, it was partially because by the time he really got going there as the starter, Tennessee already had multiple losses. We knew they weren't really going to be competing for a New Year's Six Bowl. And I think that there were people who just kind of wrote them off. And one of the things that just blew me away last year, looking back, it's one of those head-scratching things. Joe Milton winning the starting job out of camp over Hendon Hooker. Remember, Joe Milton didn't even have a spring in that offense. He made his announcement that he was going to Tennessee instead of Washington State the day that Tennessee played their spring game. He liked what he saw, apparently, from Tennessee in that spring game or the limited clips that he had or whatever it was. And I think that we went into that situation last year thinking, all right, Joe Milton kind of checks the boxes. You know, he's this physical freak. He can throw the ball out of the stadium. Unfortunately, Joe Milton threw the ball out of the stadium way too much, and they couldn't complete those deep passes. And then Hendon Hooker was perfect. And the crazy thing is, despite the fact that he has this 31-3 TD to INT ratio, one of the best quarterback rating in the country, is one of the top 10 running quarterbacks in all of college football, he's still got room to improve. He took too many sacks last year. He needs to be more decisive in that department. He can be better in the intermediate. And now that he's got an entire offseason to work with the first teamers, man, like, sky's the limit for Hendon Hooker. I'm banging the drum. He's my second best quarterback in the SEC behind Bryce Young coming into this year. If you're sleeping on Hendon Hooker, man, like, just turn out what you saw last year. The kid is really, really talented. And in that offense, I think they have a chance to be maybe the best offense in all of college football.
Connor Gurr, Saturday Down South, is our guest here on OTB. All right, let's go over to the West. Now, we know who the top team is going to be every preseason until Nick Saban retires. So Alabama certainly is there in that number one spot. But I'll be real honest with you. I have no idea, Connor, what's going to happen after Alabama, at least preseason-wise. I mean, you've got Ole Miss, who a lot of people are high on, but you lost a lot of really good players, including a Matt Corral that was one of the best quarterbacks in college football. And you know, a relative unknown, certainly in the SEC, in Jackson Dart. You lose your running back there, a couple of running backs, actually, at Ole Miss. And then you look at Texas A&M, it's like, look, until you prove me wrong, I'm going to continue to have the same feelings towards you. And, you know, LSU, new coach, new players, all that. So where do you have the West? Because right now it feels like it could truly be the wild, wild West.
Yeah, I have a slight lean to Arkansas as of right now. And I have questions. I'm
a schedule,
I think Arkansas – like, I think they're overrated coming into the year by some. I don't think they're worthy of being, like, the number 16 in the country. As I saw, like, Joel Klatt was really high on them. I've seen a few others where I'm not putting Arkansas probably in my preseason top 10. But I think A&M is still going to be the most overrated team in all of college football coming into this year. If you have A&M in your top four, you're just not paying attention at this point. Like, the fact that they lost all that talent in the front seven, they're replacing Mike Elko, their stud defensive coordinator. They have an offense that just lost all these pieces on the outside. I love Devon Achane, but I still have questions about the pieces in place for whoever their starting quarterback is going to be. Max Johnson, who had the most casual 27-6 TD to INT ratio in the history of college football, and Haynes King, who, like, Haynes King is just kind of this unknown. He played five quarters of football last year. It's because we thought he was going to be good last year doesn't mean that's a guarantee. So A&M is not worthy of being a preseason top four team. I have a little bit more faith in Arkansas just because that offense, we know they're going to run the football really well. They had the number one rushing offense in the SEC last year. I'm optimistic that KJ Jefferson can take the next step, but can Jaden Hazelwood be that wide receiver one? He wasn't that at Oklahoma. They want him to be that. They don't need him to be Treylon Burks 2.0, but they need him to be a go-to guy. And can KJ Jefferson trust those other guys? That's the question that I have, because I think from a defensive standpoint, with what they return, with Jalen Catalan, with Bumper Pool, and then adding Drew Sanders from Alabama, which is a massive addition for what they need from a pass rushing standpoint, I think Arkansas has the most tools in place in terms of what I like. But I agree with you, it's going to be all over the place. We're not really going to know week to week who that number two team is in the West, but I think Alabama, just like with Georgia in the East, is going to be heads and shoulders above the rest of the division.
Has Bumper Pool been in college since I played?
I think so, man. My, like, God. It's been a long time.
I love him.
Like, he was on the all-name team very early on, like, as a recruit. So you knew he was kind of on the radar. But it feels like he has been playing in Barry Odom's defense forever. And Jalen Catalan, I know that was kind of a surprise that he was coming back, because he got hurt last year, and there was a thinking that he was going to be going to the NFL, that he decides to run it back. So, yeah, I mean, they have some nice pieces at every level of that defense. It's just going to be a matter of putting it all together for a full season.
All right, Connor, last one before we let you go. We've got to get your breakdown, maybe some thoughts on LSU, the quarterback competition. Let's get an outsider's perspective on what you see the Tigers doing this fall.
I'm leaning Jaden Daniels. And I'm not selling my Miles Bryan stock, so this is going to sound like a massive hedge here, and maybe it is, but I think that he possesses the most tools to be able to run the offense that Brian Kelly wants to run. Here's a comp that I'd be surprised if you've seen this comp made, but it's what I keep going to. I think he does a lot of the things that Ian Book did really well for Brian Kelly's offense. And I think that's what he wants at the position. He wants somebody that when things break down, he can keep a play alive. And I'm not saying that Ian Book has quite the mobility of Jaden Daniels, but they do a lot of things really similarly. We need to see how he progresses, how he's able to work through his reads. That was his issue at Arizona State and why he didn't necessarily progress once he didn't have those stud weapons on the outside, those NFL-ready receivers. So I probably give a slight lean to Daniels, but look, I like Miles Brennan. I still really do. I just want to see the guy healthy. So to me, I look at that situation and think LSU is in a really good spot with the quarterback depth, and I don't think they're going to be in position to be all of a sudden like a vastly different team if one quarterback starts versus the other, which is essentially what Tennessee was last year.
All right, there he is, Connor O'Gara on Twitter. It's at CJ O'Gara, Saturday Down South. Connor, always appreciate time. It was great to catch up, and I will see you in Atlanta in a couple of weeks.
Sounds good. Looking forward to it, man.
All right, again, Connor O'Gara does a great job there for Saturday Down South at CJ O'Gara on Twitter. All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to do big deal or no big deal. We've also still got a couple of guests lined up. We've got Keith Marshall set to join us. Played running back at Georgia, is also doing a big NIL deal that involves the LSU Tigers. Going to have him at 9 o'clock. We're going to have LSU running back John Emery at 9:30. So a lot still to get to here on a Thursday morning edition of OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 11:30 The Tiger.
All right, go to DonsvilleGlassAndBody.com, DonsvilleGlassAndBody.com, or you can just go to DGBAuto.com. They've been doing it since 1977 out there in Deville, and it doesn't matter what your vehicle needs. We tell you all the time, and you see the video every single day if you're watching on YouTube, they are your one-stop shop. If you need an oil change, something very, very small, right? Well, they can do that. If you've got a nick in your windshield, they can repair it. If you need a full replacement, they can repair it, and they can give you a new one. Because not everybody can do that. You think, oh, well, everybody can do windshields. Actually, they can't. Certainly not with new vehicles, because here's the deal. These new vehicles, they have sensors in the windshields, and not everybody has the technology. Not everyone has that equipment to be able to replace those windshields. Of course, they have it over at Donaldsonville Glass and Body, as you saw right there on the video. So if you need that, if you need new tires, tire rotation, they can handle it. Paint and body work, we tell you every single time, the best in the state. We'll put anything on that. So go see them today, dgbauto.com, DonaldsonvilleGlassAndBody.com.
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge. Follow us on Twitter at 1045 ESPN to cast your vote in the Citizens Bank and Trust poll of the day. Vote daily inside Off the Bench, Hunt and Hill, The Early Line. And after further review, Citizens Bank and Trust brings you the poll of the day via Twitter at 1045 ESPN.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who were born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a life.
Jimmy Ott and the Handyman, live from City Slice Pints and Pizza on Chime Street, just outside the north gates of LSU, for the Thursday evening edition of Game Time, presented by Bet Rivers. NBA Draft Night, we got action. Game Time, presented by Bet Rivers of 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. The 2022 LAB Prestige Award winner for Best Sports Radio Show. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Hell of a song. Nice rejoin. Is that you, Danny? You picked that one, Danny? Right. Well done. Well done. Mario, you can appreciate that one as well.
Yes.
Right? I mean, that's peak there.
It's a classic.
That's peak there.
Makes me want to have a margarita and a cheeseburger.
Wait, a margarita. I was like, okay. And then he went cheeseburger. A margarita and a cheeseburger. What a combo.
I know it's not Jimmy Buffett, but it's got Jimmy Buffett vibes, this song.
This is a little... I'm going to be careful. I know there's a lot of people. Jimmy Buffett is talented. I'm not the biggest Jimmy Buffett. Like, I've never been to the concert. I know people that go are just... Like, I'd go see Billy Joel anywhere he was. If, like, he's like, hey, ticket, go. Like, it wouldn't matter. I would go see... I've actually seen Billy Joel in concert 3-4 times. Saw him and Elton John together. Fantastic.
Billy Joel is a legend. However, I will never forget summer 2012, I think it was. Whenever Sean Payton was suspended and Jimmy Buffett came, did the concert, was wearing the free Sean Payton shirt.
Jimmy Buffett, incredibly talented. Do not get me wrong.
Sean Payton comes out unexpectedly. Crowd goes crazy. That was an awesome concert.
Oh, I bet.
I think he's a Saints fan.
I think he's from the Gulfport area.
He was at the Saints trading camp.
Yeah. So, again. I haven't been to the concert, but there's a lot of people that love Jimmy Buffett. So nothing against Jimmy Buffett, but Billy Joel.
Cheeseburgers in paradise.
Or cheeseburgers.
Cheeseburgers and margaritas.
That is a combo. It just was.
Mario, you could have went tacos.
I was not ready for you. Yeah.
Excellent combo.
All right, let's get a little big deal or no big deal.
Deal.
No big deal.
No big deal.
No big deal.
I love the look of confusion on Mario's face. Like, what in the world just happened? No. Hey, you, dude, I'm not going to ever get mad at you. You had cheeseburgers on the mind. You can't say cheeseburger around Mario and expect him to do something 30 seconds later.
Yep.
Get it?
Lost in the sauce.
All right. Big deal or no big deal? Shohei Ohtani in the last two games. So on June 21st versus the Kansas City Royals, as a hitter, he had 2 home runs and 8 RBIs. The next night, he comes back on the mound, pitches 8 innings, and strikes out 13. So 8 RBIs the night before, he strikes out 13. This guy continues to amaze me. I feel like we never make a big enough deal about Shohei Ohtani. I mean, that is freakish. The fact that he can go out there, hit 2 home runs, 8 RBIs, and then come back and strike out 13 the next night. Big deal, no big deal.
It's a big deal, but it's also not a big deal because did the Angels win the game or lose the game?
They won the game.
Okay.
They won.
It is a big deal.
They won 5-0.
It is a big deal. As you know, not a huge baseball person, but I follow it for early line. And every time there's an Angels headline, I feel it's like Mike Trout hits his millionth home run. Shohei Ohtani does something that hasn't been done since Joe Blow did it in 1904, but the Angels still fall to the White Sox 8-5. Like, that's every single time I read about the Angels.
I mean, that's actually a really good point. So my younger brother, I don't know how in the hell this happened. He's an Angels fan. Y'all think I'm all over the map? He is completely all over the map.
Jaguars fan, too.
Yeah. Jags, Angels, basketball night. He's the biggest Pelicans fan, like, literally you'll ever meet. But he's just kind of all over the map with his teams. And I always ask him, I'm like, dude, how in the world? Like, you have maybe the best baseball player in a generation in Mike Trout, and nobody knows about him.
That's
if
insane.
If Mike Trout walked into walk-ons on Burbank right now, not a single soul, I think, would stop him.
Nobody would know who he is.
Not one time. And that is nuts to me. That is crazy. And they're not like they're in Milwaukee. They're in Anaheim, which is obviously, I mean, it's L.A., like, that to me, it kind of shows you where baseball's at a little bit, but also shows you where that organization is at. But I will still say what you're doing out there for Shohei Ohtani, that to me, being a baseball old head, that is a giant deal. Danny, what do you think?
Yeah, huge deal. Ohtani, he, like, doesn't seem like he's human. Like, he seems like he's part android. Like,
seems like such a nice
guy,
dude.
He's, like, a specimen. Like he's, like, at least he looks like he's, like, 6'5". I don't know how tall he is, but he's massive.
Yeah.
And always smashes the ball
and always just grinning.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I feel, if he played for the Yankees or Dodgers, I mean, do we think it'd be a little bit different?
Definitely.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
The Angels seem to be kind of the redheaded stepchild of LA baseball.
It's like Clippers and Lakers.
Yeah, it's like the Mets and Yankees.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, and anywho, big deal or no big deal, Ohio State has received the trademark for the word "the" for use of clothing.
They trademarked the word "the"?
Yes.
How do you get that done?
Pretty much you can't have a clothing item, shirt, pants, anything that says the word "the" on it, or Ohio State needs to profit off of it if you're selling it.
So is it "the" followed by something else, or if it just has, like, "the"?
If it just has the "d".
Okay. Oh, my God.
Like the big font, T-H-E.
Who is the lawyer on that?
I'm not.
Well done, sir.
I'm no trademark lawyer, but I know that this took a long time to complete.
Since you were doing radio from 7 to 10 and then also from 2 to 3.
Exactly. But this was something that was 3 years in the making. The people at Ohio State really wanted this done. So props to them, I guess.
Danny, what do you think?
I mean, big deal. We trademarked the word. I mean,
it's a pretty big deal.
Yeah. I don't even know how you get that done. I mean, 3 years, 5 years, 10 years. How do you get that done? It's a big deal because that lawyer deserves to be recognized. I'll give you that.
Well said.
I'll go one right here while young Danny's probably trying to find his. Big deal or no big deal, NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell. Now, Goodell testified Wednesday before members of Congress at a hearing by the House Committee on Oversight and Reform. He was asked what he was willing to do about Dan Snyder and the toxic workplace environment that they had there for the Commanders, and kind of asked him, hey, will you remove him? That was the question. Will you remove him, Dan Snyder? And he said, I don't have the authority to remove him. Big deal or no big deal?
That's a big deal. Goodell's so full of it. He's literally the commissioner. He has the authority to do whatever.
Now, he works for the owners. I actually think that he's probably factual, the fact that he technically can't do anything, but I also think it's weak as hell, the fact that nobody has that authority. Because as a player, if I screw up, I'm done. If a coach screws up, he's done. GM, done. The owners, well, they could do whatever they want. And Roger Goodell, who is the enforcement in the NFL, works for them. Yeah. So they can do whatever they want. And Roger is just going to be a little puppy because he can't do anything. Like, he doesn't have that power. And they pay him $30-whatever million per year, so he's not going to do anything. So for me, like, who do the owners have to answer to? And the question is, it's nobody. So for that reason, it's a big deal.
Yeah, it is a big deal. And he also said he didn't know that Dave Portnoy was banned from NFL events, which there's no way that's the case. That's perjury.
Yeah.
Barstool people about to come for him too.
Yeah, big deal. Like you said, like he should definitely not be. Dan Snyder should definitely not be with Washington. But yeah, and I thought the porn doll whole thing was super funny because he definitely knows who he is.
Yes, in the chat, everyone's saying like you can't do anything without a vote. Yeah, that's what we're saying. We know that. We know that that's factual. That he has to have the vote. I don't know if Lars is talking about this, said no big deal, know the rules. I don't know if he's referring to this. We do know the rules, and we know that it has to be a vote. We're saying that that is not a good practice. The fact that they don't have to answer to anyone when, as a player, we had to answer to everything in any corner we turned around, like we had to have an answer for it. So for me, that's going to be a big deal. Mario, you got any more?
Big deal or no big deal, Chet Holmgren. I just feel like he's not going to be very good in the NBA. I know that his three-point percentage is really good, but just look at him. Like, with no disrespect intended, I just don't think he has the frame to be a good NBA player. So I think him being drafted tonight is no big deal.
So I got to take my Gonzaga fandom out of this. I still think he has a role. Now, as far as, like, surefire number one pick, I don't know, because we didn't see him take over. He was the third best player on Gonzaga this year. Nembhard and Drew Timmy were better players.
Uh-huh.
So the potential's there. His skill set is unique. He's going to have to change his frame, and that's not me trying to be funny here. I mean, look, he's going to get bounced around in the NBA. Like, you can be slender, but you've got to have some mass to you. I don't think he goes number one overall like initially they thought. I think Jabari Smith's going to be the number one pick. I think Chet Holmgren might fall to three. I don't know that he'll fall past two, but it just feels like he might go three. So it does feel like he's got a little bit of a slide. It definitely, the system, he can't go to every system. The system that he goes to is going to be crucial. So I'll be interested to see where he goes. So I'll say no big deal because I don't think he's going to go number one, but I do understand, Mario, what you're saying. Danny, what do you think? Do you know who Chet Holmgren is?
Yeah. I mean, Anthony Davis was super skinny as well coming out of college.
That's true. He was.
I think he should be able to bulk up, but I've seen his defensive highlights. The dude, he's a menace on defense. Like,
yeah,
I think he'll succeed in that NBA.
AD is like a best case scenario, but he could also be another like JaVale McGee, which is what I think will happen.
JaVale McGee won world championships and also has a gold medal.
Yes, in 17 years, Chet Holmgren can be contributing to championship teams. But off the bat, as a top five pick, I don't know. I sound like a big Chet Holmgren hater right now. I'm not. I just think you could teach Banchero to shoot. You can't teach Holmgren to get bigger.
Also, Holmgren could be the highest selected Minnesota Rays player since Kevin McHale.
Oh. Okay, see? Look at that little fun fact. I didn't even know that. I knew he was the number one player in the country coming out of Minnesota, but I didn't know that. Mikhail Facto, nice job there, Danny. Big deal or no big deal, Pistol Pete finally getting a statue.
It's a huge
deal. He's getting a statue July 25th of this year. A lot of people probably already assume that he had a statue. Now there's rules and there's a process to get a statue and to get an LSU Hall of Fame and just a bunch of stuff. The building's named after him. I think a statue is probably long overdue for Pistol Pete. I think it's kind of a big deal because I think a lot of LSU fans, like even big LSU fans, would probably assume that Pistol Pete would have a statue in front of the PMAC, the Pete Maravich Assembly Center.
Yeah, no disrespect to Shaq, but I think this statue should have came first. I mean, Pete Maravich is a legend. I think they should re-retire his jersey at Smoothie King Center too. It was hung in the rafters for a long time, and now it's not anymore. And I know he's not from New Orleans, but he played for the Jazz, and down the road in Baton Rouge, he made college basketball history. So that should be the next step for Pistol Pete. Statue's a big deal.
Yeah, I also thought they already had a statue of Pistol Pete, so I assumed that. But yeah, big deal.
We got some in the chat, and our resident track fan who's been a little spicy lately, Bilbo Baggins. Big deal or no big deal, referring to any American sport championship as world champions.
Get over yourself. It's fun to say. World champions. When LSU won the title, I said campeones del mundo. It was going to be part of it. So, yeah, world champs. I mean, they're the only part of the world that's competing on this stage. So, yeah, world champs.
I got into the because I was just actually listening. Kelly O'Hare, who plays for the United States women's national team, she kind of had the same argument. She's like, because I was doing the interview on Zoom, and in the background, like, I think we have like a miniature BCS trophy or whatever, and she was talking about, she's like, well, you know, actually soccer, we're world champions. Y'all are just like American champions. I had no rebuttal. I didn't really have a rebuttal, but you know what? A lot of people have that, but our track guy, spicy Bilbo Baggins. Dane, do you have any big deal or no big deals?
I do not.
Oh my God. Mario, how long did I give him?
Dang it, Dane.
I was looking, I couldn't find anything.
I mean, I'll save it. Last one. Big deal or no big deal, Elvis movie tonight. Now, we were going to go as a unit. T-Bob screwed that up. He's not a Foxhole guy, but y'all know me. I can't wait till he gets back, so I'm going to go see it. Y'all are not Elvis fans like I was growing up, so I want to know from y'all, big deal or no big deal, Elvis movie.
Big deal. Elvis was revolutionary to music. I told y'all the other day I was watching a video about the most important moments in music history, and number two was Elvis on the Ed Sullivan Show, gyrating his hips, and they had to censor him at first, but it kind of gave way to a lot of, you know, current music and choreography, so Elvis is a legend. Big deal.
All right. Love that answer, Mario. Danny?
Big deal. I'm very interested to see how they tell like the ending of his life. I don't know if they're going to do that.
Yeah, me too. Me too. Obviously, like the ending was not great. Some uppers, some downers, and you know, passed away at 42 years old. And how he passed away, I wonder how they are going to touch that as well. I'm intrigued by that. I'm also intrigued by how they handle like him going to the army, meeting his wife Priscilla, and her age, like all of that. I'm kind of curious how they're going to kind of portray that, if you will. All right, that's it for big deal or no big deal. When we come back, Mario is going to pretty much take the ship here because we're going to talk NBA drafts. He's going to give us what the Pelicans are thinking, who he hopes falls to the Pelicans. Do the Pelicans make a move? We'll have that for you when we come back here on OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
All right, go to airflownow.com, airflownow.com. We tell you about it every single day. And look, we really don't have to tell you about the South Louisiana Heat because It's here. Remember in the spring when we had that nice weather and we're like, hey, you know what? Okay, well, it's going to be hot. And you probably believed us because, oh man, good throw, Mario, because it is South Louisiana. But look, it is here. And if you want to keep yourself safe, if you want to make sure that you have that Tiger Air insert inside your hard hat, go to airflownow.com. Listen, I mean, that is through a windscreen. It's supposed to stop the wind. But that's just on the second level, too, by the way. There's multiple levels to this. 8 hours of runtime. You only have to charge it for 2 hours to be fully charged. It's only 3.5 ounces. It clips right into your hard hat. We tell you all the time, that's it. Clips right in. So go check it out on the website. Check out that Tornado by Tiger Air. Keep your hard hat cool. Keep your body cool. Airflownow.com.
In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
Come on over to Corvall Toyota to pre-order your next vehicle. It's an easy and stress-free process. Browse, reserve, pick up, and enjoy. It's that simple. So come on down to Happy Town. That's Corvall Toyota in Opelousas, Happy Town, USA.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
There it is, the extra mile, on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected, supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded, because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
If you're in an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law office of O.C. Brown.
At the law office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
And this year, 2022, it's time to finally treat yourself. Bring your boat to the next level with front-to-back boat service. You want the latest and greatest marine technology? You want to go to the place that has not one, but two NMEA certified techs. Family owned and operated by the Sherman family for 30 years, front-to-back is the answer in Baton Rouge for all of your custom boat needs. So head to fronttobackboatservice.com or find them on Facebook, front-to-back boat service.
For a Thursday edition of Hunt and Hill, Aaron Murray of the SEC Network joins us to talk football, and we talk about the misery that is the College World Series. Join us noon to 2 every weekday. It's Hunt and Hill, 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
All right, welcome back in, OTB. Before we get to the NBA draft talk, I'm going to tell you about DraftKings. Now, I'm sure they're going to have fantastic props for the NBA draft, so go ahead, download that app, and make sure you check them all out, right? And you can go pick by pick. You can have a lot of fun tonight. Also, when you download that DraftKings Sportsbook app, use promo code Baton Rouge, all one word. Bet $5 on any UFC 276 fighter to win and get $100 in free bets no matter what. That's code Baton Rouge. That's this Saturday at DraftKings Sportsbook, the official sports betting partner of UFC.
Remember, you got to be 21 or older, physically present in Louisiana. Availability varies by parish. Eligibility restrictions apply. Minimum $5 deposit. See DraftKings.com/sportsbook for full terms and conditions. Licensee partner, Golden Nugget Lake Charles. Gambling problem? Call 1-877-770-STOP. 7867.
Yeah, when I read UFC 276 there, I remember UFC 1. That's why I paused there. Hurts. UFC like 1. Y'all, before we get to it, real quick. Bless you, by the way, Danny. Are y'all old enough to remember when there was no weight classes in the UFC and it was like tournament style and they would like fight multiple fights? And it would be like you could have a sumo wrestler versus somebody that was like a buck 65.
Was Chuck Liddell doing that?
I don't think Chuck Liddell was. No, he wasn't doing that yet. This is like Ken Shamrock. I think Ken Shamrock was. You remember Ken Shamrock?
It rings a bell. But
Gracie.
My earliest memories of like combat fighting or Chuck Liddell just messing people up.
All right.
Yeah, I don't remember that.
Yeah, I hate y'all. I hate y'all by y'all's age. All right, NBA draft. It is tonight. We are all excited. The Pelicans made the playoffs, made a run, looked really good doing so. They've got a young roster. They have a talented roster. And, oh, yeah, they did all of that without Zion Williamson. Our hopes are that he is fully back next year. So you add that piece already. And thank you, Lakers. You add a lottery pick to an already very deep, talented roster. You could get creative tonight. You do have pieces that if you want to move on from. Devontae Graham, reports are he's been shot for picks and maybe packaging him together with the Wizards. You've got Kyra Lewis, who I'm not saying you should trade him, but you could be creative. You do. It's a little bit of a lagniappe piece for you right now since you go get CJ. And obviously, Jose was able to step up and got a new contract, and he kind of came out of nowhere. And so he's also in line to get plenty of guard minutes as well. So we'll kind of see what they do, how aggressive they are. But Mario, our NBA expert, certainly our Pelicans expert here, what do you think the Pelicans do tonight?
It's really hard to say, man. But if we're going to go by betting favorites here on who's going to be drafted by the Pelicans, you know, I host a gambling show. It's a three-way tie right now with Dyson Daniels, AJ Griffin, and Shaedon Sharpe. For me, I really like Griffin. He only played 1 year at Duke, but he's a really good three-point shooter. He's a really good defender, and that's kind of what the Pelicans need. That being said, I don't think they're going by need. I think they're going to take the best player who's available here since they have kind of a lot of depth, like you alluded to. So I would not be surprised to see them pick one of those three people, but it could go either way. A lot of options.
They do have a lot of options, and that's a great place to be where they're at. Right, they have the option to trade back. Now, I don't think they'll trade up, but if they wanted to, they have some pieces that I think would be enticing to other teams.
And I think trading for future first-round picks would be a possibility. Maybe you trade
so you
back.
Think so even kind of, I mean, I know they gave up some of their treasure chest, but they still have plenty in there. You still think that would be something that they could possibly do?
If they're going to trade the pick, I think that's something that they would do. I don't think they want two picks from this draft, but maybe more assets down the road. And I was talking with Brian Haldane on his show this morning, Talk 107.3. Anything is really on the table. Like, I don't think they'll make a trade, but I also don't know who's available. Like, if there's a world where you can get Donovan Mitchell or DeAndre Ayton, maybe that's something that they would explore. I don't see it happening, but I also didn't think that C.J. McCollum was available. And I really liked Josh Hart before they got C.J. McCollum. So
right.
You never know what they're going to do here. That's what makes the draft so exciting.
So some of the rumors that I've heard are, you know, possibly trading picks with the Wizards and involving Devontae Graham in that. So what would you expect to get back? You'd get the 10th pick. Is there a player on the Wizards that maybe there's a contract? Maybe they're trying to offload that contract. I mean, you're probably trying to do a lot of the same with Graham. Not trying to get someone maybe that you'll even cut, but just trying to trade contract for contract.
Maybe KCP. I think he's on an expiring contract. Caldwell Pope on the Wizards. Came over in the trade with Kuzma from the Lakers. That would be a step up from Devontae Graham, and it really does look like they're trying to shop him, so that would not surprise me at all.
Because they're in that territory in the draft, sitting there at 8, and like you mentioned, there's a couple, three players maybe that they could be targeting right there. There's not going to be a huge difference, it feels like, in this draft, right? If there was a big difference, if you have one of those drafts where, you know, you felt like 8 could get you a really, really, like, superstar talent, There's good players, I think, at 8. I don't know that there's a game changer there at 8. So if you fall back to 10, I really don't think that hurts you that much. You can't see any scenario, Mario, where they trade up, could you? Just in this draft,
small chance. Maybe if like Jaden Ivey drops to number 5, if they want to go up and get him, I could see the Pelicans make a trade for Jaden Ivey. Maybe Keegan Murray from Iowa.
That's who I want. I want Keegan Murray. I don't think he's going to be there. Right now, he's the 5th best available on ESPN.com on their draft analyst, so I don't think he'll be there at 8.
He's a beast. 23.5 points per game is no joke, but if the Pelicans do trade up, it would for sure have to be for one of those two guys.
Sitting here, I'm looking at the list, and I know we talked about Tar Eason. He's rated there at 16. Wonder where Tar is going to go. I know Cody mentioned the Spurs being linked there. That would kind of be above, obviously, where they have him there. Johnny Davis from Wisconsin, somebody that I like. Obviously, he's a two guard, 6'5", 194, out of Wisconsin. Played a lot of basketball. Somebody that kind of, I don't want to say like came out of nowhere, but he's got a really good story. He's won a gold medal with USA basketball as well. Is Johnny Davis somebody that, he sits there right now, and I'm looking at the pre-draft analyst at number 10. Is that somebody you think the Pelicans could be interested in?
Yeah, got injured towards the end of the year with Wisconsin. Got to point that out, but a very gifted scorer. I think the Pelicans would be interested in him. And also Sochan out of Baylor, foreign player. The Pelicans love drafting foreign players for whatever reason. He's a little bit more developed, and he got caught by a couple Pelicans fans having dinner with David Griffin the other day.
Ooh.
So they're definitely interested in Sochan from Baylor.
All right, so let me tell you from – well, let me do this because we got to go to break. I'll kind of tell you on the other side what that means on the NFL side of things when someone like that goes to the dinner. We'll have that for you when we come back, OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
927-8300 is the number. 927-8300 is the number. And you go there, you're going to get a beautiful new roof every shingle time. Call them up. When they answer the phone, hit them with the roofs. And then be like, hey, but seriously, I need you to come out and see what's going on with my roof. And they're going to be like, all right, cool. It's really easy to schedule a time. And then guess what? It's free to get that estimate. That's right. A free professional estimate. It costs you nothing for them to come out of your home. Once the work begins, right, you make a fully informed decision. Then once the work begins, everybody's licensed, bonded, and insured. They offer a 2-year workmanship guarantee on top of the manufacturer warranty. I tell you about it every day, right? Because I want to reinforce that Go Roof is just about the customer, okay? They're about maximizing the community's roofing needs, and they stand by their work before, during, and after the process. Go to geauxroof.com. Go Roof!
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Andiamo insieme da me, non c'è.
Oh, oh, oh.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs, upgrades, and installations.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
There's nothing better than tailgating, but it can be a lot of work. So why do it yourself when you don't have to? Let Revelry Sports and Entertainment set up your luxury tailgate on campus. Order what you want and just show up to party. Book your tailgate today at revelryteam.com. Revelry Sports, the official tailgate partner of LSU Athletics.
There it is, the extra mile on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play. With safety and tech to keep you connected. Supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team. And backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
Light beer shouldn't taste like water. Miller Lite has more taste and only 96 calories. It's Miller time.
My own people call me an Uncle Tom. I play music. Been wine and dine by royalty. Trying to bring people together. All people. But regardless of all that kind of stuff, I'm still Louis Armstrong.
Here's the man you're waiting for, the king of jazz, Louis Latchmo Armstrong.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way. But unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support.
5ESPN and Guarantee Media bring you Drop Biscuit Studios. It's a southern home for storytellers. Visit dropbiscuit.com today and check out the trailer to our first original series, Pops, The Louis Armstrong Story, starring Reno Wilson. Subscribe today. All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
All right, welcome back in. OTB, real quick to kind of finish up that story. He mentioned NBA prospect meeting, having dinner with David Griffin and why that's important. I can just tell you from my experience, I only got offered a contract and a free agent dinner whenever the brass was there. When Chicago, no brass, no contract. Tampa Bay, no brass, no contract. Detroit, no brass, no contract. Went to Seattle, John Schneider, Pete Carroll, both there at the dinner, got offered a contract. In Denver, John Elway, John Fox, at the dinner, got offered a contract. The brass only comes if they're highly interested and they intend on you being on their team, just in my experience. Whenever they weren't, they send you with a scout or maybe the assistant GM. That meant that they, were just kind of doing their homework, maybe having you on the back burner for later. But if they had someone show up to that dinner, they meant business. You were going to get offered a contract. And so that is not, nothing. That is something for sure. That is a big deal whenever David Griffin is having dinner with an NBA prospect. All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, Keith Marshall, former UGA running back, now with the Players Lounge, will join us here on OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
All right, go to RejuveMeMedical.com, RejuveMeMedical.com. Sometimes you get reminders that you're not as good as you once were. Just sometimes that happens. Maybe you're trying to pull some parachutes and maybe do some ladder drills with your 12, 10, 9, and 6-year-old, and you're trying to jump in there with them, and the next day you're trying to walk up the stairs, and you're like, that doesn't feel right. Well, if that's you, like you're looking in the mirror, then you need to go to RejuveMeMedical.com. They can help you get on a path, get on a plan to feel like your youthful self. So if you're 37, help you feel like you're 27. So RejuveMeMedical.com is a site. They help you get that three-step process to figure out what's going on with you. So many different conditions that they do treat. Fatigue and insomnia, right? Maybe you're always tired, you can't sleep, can't figure it out. Mood and memory problems. Sexual dysfunction, weight gain, gaining weight, can't explain it. They do all of that over at Rejuve Me Medical. Call them today, 225-230-4201.
Follow us on Twitter at 1045ESPN to cast your vote in the Citizens Bank and Trust poll of the day. Vote daily inside Off the Bench, Hunt and Hill, the early line. And after further review, Citizens Bank and Trust brings you the poll of the day via Twitter at 1045ESPN.
Bayou Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram has new 2021 Jeep Wranglers and Jeep Gladiators on our lot now with $5,000 off MSRP. And all new Bayou vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. If you need sales or service, the crew at Bayou is going to do right by you.
Miller Lite has more taste and only one more calorie than Michelob Ultra.
Join 100.7 The Tiger and Our Lady of the Lake Ascension Saturday, June 25th at the Lamar Dixon Expo Center in Gonzales.
Enjoy live music from Ted Durr, Mike Broussard and the Night Train, and Jamie Badron and the Kickin' Cajuns. Make sure you grab a delicious plate of jambalaya from the Mike Ward's Liberty Safe's Jambalaya Cook-Off to raise money for the Alzheimer's services of the capital area.
The Swamp Pop Music Festival with Supreme Chevrolet.
Louisiana's Country Station.
100.7 The Tiger.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who are born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Andiamo insieme da me, non c'è.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs, upgrades, and installations.
Good morning. It's 9 a.m. on Thursday, June 23rd. Your government taco forecast today in Baton Rouge expects sunny skies with a high of 99. Government taco, where our pickled onions always make a taco wet. Coming up on OTBOT, Keith Marshall, the CEO of the Players Lounge, joins the show up next, and LSU running back John Emery joins us at 9:15. You can follow today's show on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok at OTB_ESPN. Or watch us on YouTube at the 104.5 ESPN channel and subscribe for daily content. OTBOT, live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge studio, starts now.
Let him go!
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Jacob Hester and T-Bob Hebert.
Yeah!
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Hey, T, they said I gotta come off the bench.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. Yo, yo, yo.
Yo, welcome in. Hour number three of OTB here on a Thursday morning. Very excited for our next guest to join us. He is the co-founder and CEO of the Players Lounge, something you've heard us talk about here, obviously helping out LSU athletes. He's also someone who played running back at Georgia, was a draftee of the Washington Commanders back in 2016. That is Keith Marshall, who joins us now. Keith, how are you doing this morning?
Hey, man, I'm doing great, man. How are you guys doing?
We're doing well. Glad to have you on. And before we get to anything, I'm sitting here and I'm checking out the bio. I'm doing my homework, having you on, excited to have you on. But you ran, let's talk about this. You ran a 4.31 at 5'11", 222 pounds. What in the absolute hell, Keith? How did you get that done?
Man, that is my one claim to fame, if I'm being honest. You know, I was one of those guys. Coming up, I was a track guy, so ran my whole life, and that was always kind of my cup of tea, bread and butter, even when it came to football. So It was surprising to a lot of people, but not really to us that had been around.
Not surprising to you, maybe, but I'm sitting here, I'm like, man, I definitely remember when you played at Georgia. I remember your career. I remember how you were a big back like I was. Keith, breaking news, I didn't run a 4.31 at the combine. Didn't happen. I don't know if you knew that, but that is not what happened for me. Probably shocked you there, right?
Absolutely, man. Well, you know, you were a little bit bigger than me, too. I'm assuming of being a fullback. You know, I was probably too big at the combine, to be completely honest. I should have been a lot smaller, so.
Yeah, I tried to do the old trick where I was like tweener weight, like 28 at the combine. Because, like, hey, I could play running back. They're like, no, dude, you just ran a 4.6. You're going to be a fullback. And so we can definitely hash that story out in a little bit, Keith. But, man, I'm so excited to have you on because, as we mentioned, co-founder, CEO of the Players Lounge. Now, we've certainly had our guy Aaron Murray on the show. He's talked about the Players Lounge. We just had Peter Burns of the SEC Network. He talked about his NFT and his avatar. He finally got that created. We're going to have John Emery, LSU running back, on the show in about 30 minutes from now. So our listeners kind of know about the Players Lounge, but I wanted to have you on so you could explain it. Like, obviously, being the co-founder, kind of where this started, where the passion came from, and exactly maybe what the goal was initially and kind of how it's growing.
Absolutely, man. Well, I think, you know, to start it off, you know, with any startup, you start with one idea, and then as you kind of respond to the market and learn your consumers, you switch over time. So, I mean, to be completely honest, when we came together in November, the idea was to drop an NFT project similar to Bored Ape and CryptoKitty, some of the popular projects around UGA football, partnering with the athletes and doing so, because obviously they had a lot of momentum last year, and we were hoping that we could generate a nice little chunk of change and get the guys paid. As we began pushing, it became clear that, you know, a lot of the people we were trying to sell to were not overly familiar with crypto.
Right.
And so over time, that has somewhat faded into the background, and it's really shifted to be more about, you know, player engagement, player empowerment in this world of NIL. And what I mean by that is, and you'll be able to appreciate this, for when we played, obviously the way that fans consumed information from the athletes was via these third-party media houses. So, you know, Scout, right. Rivals, ESPN, 247. Now, because of NIL and the advent of Web3, these kids can kind of put their message, their perspectives out there, their stories about who they are, and even, you know, tied to specifically, you know, what's going on in their athletic career, they can communicate that directly with the fans. And so our platform really provides, a method for them to do so in a way that obviously gets them paid.
And obviously, this is something, like you mentioned, you start at Georgia. I believe LSU was the second school, but this is something y'all have really grown. I mean, y'all have got kind of the who's who list of schools kind of coming up. So what's the Players Lounge have coming up before we kind of circle back to the LSU portion?
Absolutely. So you mentioned it this Saturday. We're super excited about the LSU launch. We'll have a little get-together down there in Baton Rouge to celebrate that. And then we'll kick it to next month, where we'll be releasing at Alabama, Auburn, Texas, Oklahoma, Clemson, and Tennessee. So, we definitely have a lot coming down the pipeline, just trying to take the same success that we had at Georgia and replicate that at these other universities and really be able to support athletes more broadly.
Now, Keith, what's kind of the reception been as far as like getting on the Discord and being able to have that chat? Because that's something that I don't think a lot of fans have ever really had the opportunity to do. Like, you jump on there and you've got active LSU players and certainly Georgia and the other schools, but certainly being here in Baton Rouge, we're talking LSU. I mean, you're able to hop on there and you can have conversations with Will Campbell and with Miles Brennan, John Emery, Jeray Jenkins, Malik Nabers, Kayshawn Boutte. I mean, you go on and on and on. I mean, what is kind of the feedback you've gotten from the fans being able to have that type of access?
Absolutely. So, I mean, you know, kind of using UGA as our base case, the fans absolutely love it. I think the guys love it. Getting back to kind of what we said, the overall feel of the platform is, a lot of these fans have already been in message boards on some of these other sites. And, you know, to me, this is just the next generation of that, because you have the athletes right there that you can communicate, you can get your questions answered, you can hear their perspectives, you know, on life and on what's going on in their athletic career. So, the fans are loving it. They're eating it up. Right now, we have our Georgia players going in there three nights a week. For 15 or 30 minutes, we kind of have topics that we put them in with the idea of really, again, you know, allowing the kids to kind of express themselves beyond just the regular, you know, back and forth that, you know, media does.
And obviously we've got the pictures here on our YouTube channel. We're showing all of the Georgia Bulldogs. I got to ask you, Keith, do you have a favorite? Do you have a favorite one that of a Georgia Bulldog that you saw created that caught your eye? Because as we're scrolling down here, I mean, the Georgia fellas did a nice job. They are all completely different.
Yeah, so mine obviously is my favorite, but I went for the whole I went for the kind of the business look. Like, you know, you got a little swag at the chain in there, the gold teeth, but then I'm still buttoned up, you know, with the whole CEO deal. My favorite one, though, is probably my teammate, Marlo Herrera. He played, you know, SEC linebacker. He played with us. So he created one with the Joker trade.
Yeah.
And it was everybody's favorite. And so a fan actually bought it from him for, I think, $7,500. So he no longer owns it. It's one of those ones that, you know, everybody in the ecosystem kind of recognizes as being the most legendary. But that will probably be the fan favorite.
Okay, so kind of help our listeners out. So you mentioned, like, the price and what he got it for. So, like, when that happened, so the player was able to create the NFT, create the avatar, you sell it, that player, it's an NIL deal, gets that profit, and then that person who buys it, they own it. It's theirs now for the rest of time, right?
Absolutely. So, I mean, this is kind of one of those things where we're walking a fine line in between crypto world and, you know, traditional transactions. So in crypto, obviously, to your point, the player or the person that's tied to the actual asset will get paid for it in perpetuity. The mascot drops are not, you know, replications of the athlete, so not those, but we are going to do some player cards. We'll have some more information there, particularly at LSU. And the athletes will get paid, you know, if those get traded on the secondary market forever.
All right, and there is a big launch party, and LSU's portion of this is the Bayou Cat Crew. There's a launch party June 25th that's coming up this weekend. It is from 2 to 5 p.m. It's going to be at the OG Walk-Ons. Keith, where can everyone kind of go maybe to find out more information if they want to attend this event and kind of just kind of find out a little bit more maybe about the Players Lounge in general?
Absolutely. So, you know, as you mentioned, Saturday it's on. We have our pre-sales dropping. We'll probably drop around 1,000 NFTs. So, you know, fans will get a chance to get early access to the community. To kind of figure out how you can fit into that, go join our pre-sale list. It's theplayerslounge.io. Again, that's theplayerslounge.io. If you go on the website, you'll be able to find the LSU section, the Bayou Cat Crew, and we'll have all the necessary information for you there.
All right, Keith, obviously, since we have you, and Keith Marshall is our guest here, former Georgia NFL running back, now CEO of the Players Lounge. While we have you here, certainly we got to ask you about some SEC football. We got to ask you about the Dogs. We got to ask you about maybe what you think of the upcoming season. National champs, 40-plus years, Georgia, they're able to do it. And now once you do it, it's like, okay, what can you do after that? So, like, how's the temperature in Athens, man? Last time I was there, it felt like it was all Georgia football. Fans were excited. That national championship can really unlock something.
Absolutely. I'm excited to see it. You know, for years, as you mentioned, we've been so close, and we finally got over that hump. And obviously, we know it's from a you know, resource standpoint, from the athletes we have on scholarship, the coaches, we have everything it takes to be, you know, a mainstay in college football. So I'm excited to see what they can do to kind of reload. We know they lost a lot on defense last year with the draft that was really a legendary draft. So I'm just excited to see some of these, you know, five-star top recruits step in there and replace some of those guys that we lost.
All right, there he is, Keith Marshall, former Georgia running back, now CEO of the Players Lounge. The big event coming to Walk-Ons, the launch party for the Bayou Cat Crew will be June 25th, 2 to 5 p.m. You can go to playerspresale.com now to register. Keith, man, thank you for your time so much. We appreciate it.
Absolutely, man. Appreciate all that you're doing for us. Talk to you soon.
All right, same to you. All right, and again, like if you're wondering, okay, well, why did they have that on? Because, look, no surprise here, we are LSU fans here on this show. And NIL is a space that you better be on board, right? And so fantastic stuff that Aaron Murray, Keith Marshall, former Georgia Bulldogs, they started Georgia. LSU was their next choice. So you've got some great NIL deals, and you've got them going on with some of your biggest players. We mentioned Miles Brennan and Kayshawn Boutte. You got Blake Money in baseball. You've got Trey Morgan in baseball. Peter Burns, right, big LSU guy, like he's involved in this as well. You've got Gymnast, you've got track and field, you've got Will Campbell, Emory Jones. I mean, you're BJ Ojulari, Mike Jones. I mean, I can John Emory, who's coming on in a second. Some of your biggest players, and they're bringing NIL deals to LSU, which we've all talked about so many times. The more NIL deals you can bring, obviously, it's going to be better for your program. That is the name of the game currently, right now. So that's definitely why we wanted to have Keith on, bring attention to this party, the launch party again. Bayou Cat Crew is the name of the LSU portion of this. It's, I believe DGD is the Georgia person, so Damn Good Dog, obviously, is a thing that they have there. But if you want to check it out, Bayou Cat Crew on Twitter, that's at Bayou Cat Crew. Check it out. They'll have all the information there, trying to bring some great NIL deals to the LSU football, baseball, track and field, gymnast. I mean, you name it, they've got almost every sport covered. So it's great information there. We'll kind of put that on some of our stuff as well. All right, we are going to take a break. Don't forget, we've got John Emery set to join us in about 15 minutes from now. We still got to get to Ask the Bench. Chef, by the way, people are asking in the chat. Chef is in Chicago. He's at a big conference, so he could not be with us this morning. We're going to try to catch up with Chef tomorrow, have munchies for you. I know you look forward to that every single week. We'll take a break. More to come. OTB.
OTB. OT.
All-Star Toyota of Baton Rouge.com. All-Star Toyota of Baton Rouge.com. That is the place to go. I know they have saved me with the rental process. I know when I was going to the bowl game in Houston, I had to get new tires on my car. It was in the shop, and obviously Katie needed the van. So at the time, I needed something to drive, and they put me in a Highlander. So I take the Highlander from Baton Rouge to Houston, and I enjoyed it so much that when I got back in town, not only was I renting the Highlander, I was leasing the Highlander because I had no idea that it would be able to fit my crew. As y'all know, we've got four boys. This has captain chairs in the middle. It's got a three-seater in the back. It's got room in the back, too. That's the key part of this. Not everybody's going to have that room. It's got room for bat bags, for chairs, for whatever we might need. So you never know what you're going to be able to fit into over at All-Star, but just go check it out because the full fleet is available. So many different options for you. You can check it out right now on the website, All-Star Toyota of Baton Rouge.com.
In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
My own people call me an Uncle Tom. I play music. Been wine and dine by royalty. Trying to bring people together. All people. But regardless of all that kind of stuff, I'm still Louis Armstrong.
Here's the man you're waiting for, the king of jazz, Louis Latchmo Armstrong.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge. No matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111. Your law firm for a lifetime.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
There it is, the extra mile, on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected, supported by a five-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the one star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded, because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
For a Thursday edition of Early Line, as we start looking ahead to the weekend's action and recap last night's games from Omaha and the College World Series. Plus, we look ahead to the NBA draft. Join us 2 to 3 p.m. 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Yeah. Fool. You know how we do it.
OTB OT with Hester and T-Bob on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge and 94.7 ESPN Alexandria.
All right, welcome back into OTB. We did have some sad news, incredibly sad news in the NFL. A couple of cases that I definitely wanted to make sure that we mentioned. And one of them obviously has a local tie, and that is Jalen Ferguson. Very talented football player. He was born in Zachary, went to Westfell there in St. Francisville, played college football at Louisiana Tech, played for the Baltimore Ravens, was a third-round draft choice. Played in over 30 career NFL games. I think I'm pretty sure he's the all-time sack leader in FBS history, just a dominant college player there in Ruston at Louisiana Tech. He passed away yesterday at a very, very young age, 26 years old. Details, obviously, are still coming. There was a couple of things that were out there until it's confirmed. Obviously, we'll hold off on that, but to pass away at 26 years old, it's terrible. There's nothing you can say. I mean, there's absolutely nothing you can say. Someone who had their whole life in front of them. Again, everybody you talked to at Westfell, my brother actually coaches at Westfell, and he said when he would come back, always had a smile on his face, was willing to help all the student athletes that are there at Westfell. So definitely just tragic news. 26 years old, Jalen Ferguson of the Baltimore Ravens passed away, and sadly, it wasn't the only kind of sad news that the Baltimore Ravens organization got. Tony Siragusa, obviously a lot of people know him as Goose. He passed away at the age of 55 as well. Even if you didn't see Goose play, obviously you saw him on the sidelines. He did TV for a long time as well. Boys, I don't know if y'all were old enough, but when the Ravens had the early 2000s Hard Knocks on HBO, Goose was kind of like the star of the show. I mean, he was somebody that when he popped on, I mean, he always gave you kind of the funny moments, the best moments. And he had a 12-year career, and this is somebody that was undrafted free agent. His signing bonus was $1,000 and ended up having a really nice career. So very, very sad news, certainly for the Baltimore Ravens and just everyone involved. I mean, even Goose at 55 years old. I mean, that's incredibly, incredibly young. I told you my father just celebrated his 65th birthday, and I can't imagine, you know, losing someone at the age of 55. And so thoughts, prayers go out to both families. Just incredibly sad news on both fronts. And so definitely wanted to mention that. Definitely something that you hate mentioning, but you want to definitely remember those men. I mean, young man, God, Jalen Ferguson, 26 years old, just heartbreaking. So when more news comes, obviously we'll update you here on OTB. All right, no easy way, obviously, to transition from that. But again, I felt like they definitely needed to be recognize and pay respect to both families there. Something that, Mario, I'm sure that you've talked about on your show, there's Heisman odds are really starting to become in vogue. You're starting to see them all over the place. And so I'm going to quiz you a little bit here. All right. This is courtesy of Vegas Insider. Which LSU player do you think has the best odds to win the Heisman Trophy?
Got to be Kayshawn Boutte.
Danny, you want to take a guess there too?
Boutte.
Both of you would be wrong.
Okay.
It's actually a tie. Jaden Daniels and Miles Brennan, both at plus 6,600.
Throw your money away.
So that's what makes this quarterback battle interesting, though. Like, no one knows. You have your best Heisman odds as two quarterbacks with the same odds. Because I really don't think anybody knows how this thing is going to play out. There's some that believe that both will actually get an opportunity to play. You're going to have different quarterbacks, different packages. I don't know that that's going to be the case. I mean, we could go back and we can find it in Brian Kelly and Denbrock's history where they played multiple quarterbacks. Don't know how it's going to play out. I mean, it is definitely a competition. I think Garrett Nussmeier is still firmly in this competition. When Connor O'Gara, who joined us from Saturday Down South, when he was talking about kind of the in-book comp to Jaden Daniels, I was thinking Garrett Nussmeier. If you're looking for a comp for Ian Book, I think it's more Nussmeier than it is Jaden Daniels, so don't rule him out there. One thing I did find interesting, though, about the plus 6,600, that is the same odds as Will Levis, who on every single first-round mock draft is in the top 10 from Kentucky. Okay, so that's where they have LSU's quarterbacks. Also, I saw an article that had top five quarterback rooms in the country. LSU was number five on that list, so people think they have talent in that room. Don't know who's going to win that job. They also had better odds than Devin Leary from NC State, who's a player that y'all have heard me talk about him before. I think he is going to be firmly in that Heisman conversation. In fact, my boldest take of the college football year is that NC State will win the ACC. So, yeah, you got to go down the list to find them, plus 6,600, but they got better odds than some really good college football players that have done way more than both those young men have done on the field. And so that is encouraging, right? If you're trying to find some positives there and you go down the list, y'all's answer, Kayshawn, was actually plus 8,000. So not too far behind where the two quarterbacks kind of came in. But it is wild that in this day and age, and look, we just did it. We had a segment where we talked about NIL for 15 minutes and the importance of NIL and trying to find ways to get guys some NIL deals and so you can get the best roster that you possibly can have. So that's really been the conversation. Like, there's not been the position by position breakdown yet. I mean, normally by the time you get to like June 23rd, you've had that 3 weeks ago. We haven't had that yet because college landscape has changed so much. We haven't had the quarterback battle debate. Typically, every single day when we came on the radio, when there's a quarterback battle, it's like we talk about it over and over and over again until we're just blue in the face and we try to find ways to make a case for everyone to start and everyone to sit. Like, we haven't had that yet because, I mean, it's just, it has changed. The landscape's changed. So you're talking about other things. And so there's going to be a point where we get to that conversation. Certainly that will heat up as July comes. Media Day is going to be there. Does Brian Kelly bring a quarterback to Media Days? Remember, JT Daniels was the rep for Georgia last year at SEC Media Days. JT Daniels, as y'all know, is now the quarterback at West Virginia. Stetson Bennett won a national championship. So I'm not saying that it's the say-all, be-all, but it is a very important kind of gesture to see, you know, maybe who the starting quarterback would be if you do invite that quarterback to Media Days. And so I want to ask you, Mario, obviously, like, this is something you pay attention to, not just the betting portion of this, but LSU football. Jaden Daniels, Miles Brennan, Garrett Nussmeier. We'll start to break it down when T-Bob gets back from his 37th vacation. But any way that you're leaning currently right now?
Maybe not towards one particular quarterback to actually start, but I think Nussmeier is being slept on a little bit. He's going to definitely be part of the competition. Not many memorable plays on the Spanish broadcast last season, but one of them was the touchdown pass that he had against Arkansas off his back foot. He's really physically gifted, and he's going to be a factor in the quarterback race, I think.
My only concern, right, because whoever wins the job wins the job. Love Miles Brennan's story. Y'all know that. Love Miles' story. Didn't take his ball and go home. Stayed the course. There's been many times when this day and age of college football, Miles leaves and then leaves probably three different times. He didn't do that. So love his story. And there's a piece of me that's certainly rooting for him. Jaden Daniels comes in, wants to bet on himself, wants to compete. Nothing more I love than a competitor. I love someone that bets on themselves, says, no, I can go do that. Like I told y'all many, many times, Joey Hester's famous quote, if you're scared of competition, change your last name. Try to live by that, okay? And then you got Nuss. And then you got Garrett Nussmeier, who's always kind of been this wild card, right? Last year, he's like, hey, just let me play. Let me show what I can do. I remember being on the sidelines of the Ole Miss game, and he's just pacing back and forth. Remember, LSU had no success that day. And he's just begging, like, hey, let me get a chance. Give me an opportunity, right? So he's got that fire in him as well. So I'm not even talking about, like, who it should be right now. We'll have that conversation. But you don't want to have three quarterbacks 2 weeks before you play Florida State. You can't. It can't be the case. In fact, I'd like to have two with a heavy lean to one when you're 2 weeks out. Because during training camp, and certainly with the new rules, you only have so much time that you get to work with the ones. And if you're rolling in Miles for three, Jaden for three, Nuss for two, and you're trying to figure it out that way with the ones, not only does that quarterback not to create that chemistry with the offensive line, but the offensive line doesn't get to figure out the quarterback's cadence. The running back doesn't get to figure out how he hands the ball off. The receivers don't get to figure out how the ball spins coming out of his hands. And trust me, that's important. They might sound like the silliest thing in the world. There was a gigantic difference in the way that Jamarcus handed the football off to the way Matt handed the football off. It's just the case. I remember. Now, obviously, their height had to play into it, but Jamarcus was a guy. He extended it way farther than Matt did. Matt kind of had more of a tucked elbow, and you're like, hey, that's silly. No, it's not. I mean, all of that, you know, if you don't have it right, it leads to turnovers. It leads to fumbles. So I want to have a better idea of who your quarterback is. You come into training camp. It's 4 weeks right before the first game. That first week, you can let everybody have a shot. Get some reps. Get some rotation going. But as soon as you get to that second week, it's two. And then once you get to that third week, it's one. And then you give your starter 2 weeks to prepare for Florida State. Remember, Florida State has a game. They've got a week zero game against an FCS opponent, right? So that gives them an advantage. We saw UCLA had the same advantage a year ago when they played Hawaii in week zero. They play LSU. They look like a team that played a game. LSU looked like a team that did not play a game. So you are already at somewhat of a disadvantage. So go in, have a competition, know what that competition looks like after week one. Week two, know what it looks like. Week three, week four, you're my starter. That's who we have moving forward. So we'll definitely pay attention to that and see how that plays out as we get closer and closer to football season. We'll dive into some of those topics we already would have covered about 3 weeks, maybe even a month probably, leading into the summertime radio. All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to be joined by LSU running back John Emery here on Off the Bench.
OTB. OT.
Go to centralplumbing.org. Central Plumbing. I felt like T-Bob there for a second. Centralplumbing.org. It is always the go-to, any issue that you might have. But I'll get to the issues in a little bit. It doesn't have to be an issue. It can just be an upgrade. It can be something where you've got a space at your home or business that you want to upgrade and look better. You want to modernize maybe your restroom. Maybe you want to change out your shower. Maybe you want to change out your flooring, your vanity, your mirror, whatever it might be. They can also come in and do all that. So it's not only emergency services. Now, certainly they can handle any of that. You see right there on the homepage, they also can upgrade, remodel for you. Also, if you want to go tankless water heater, that's home or business as well. Certainly at your home, though. Like me, you got four kids. You're coming in late after a ball game, laundry, dishes. You're trying to do all of it at once. You're trying to shower as well to get ready for bed. You never run out of hot water. It is a game-changing lifesaver for us and our family. Call them today to install that tankless water here, 225-925-8552.
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
There it is, the extra mile on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further. Like vans customized for work or play. With safety and tech to keep you connected. Supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team. And backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
Follow us on Twitter at 1045ESPN to cast your vote in the Citizens Bank and Trust poll of the day. Vote daily inside Off the Bench, Hunts and Hill, The Early Line. And after further review, Citizens Bank and Trust brings you the poll of the day via Twitter at 1045ESPN.
If you're in an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the law office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All Star Toyota today.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Light beer shouldn't taste like water. Miller Lite has more taste and only 96 calories. It's Miller.
Gonna invite you to join us for Thursday's AFR presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. I'm out. Leah Van of The Advocate will be here talking LSU baseball roster and previewing the NBA draft. 3-6, 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
OTB, OT, with Hester and T-Bob on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge and 94.7 ESPN Alexandria.
All right, welcome back in. We are still trying John Emery this morning, so I'm just going to make Mario continue to call and call and call and call until we see if we can get John here. I know they had a workout that was supposed to wrap up at about 9:15, so obviously we'll see if we can get John Emery set there. Obviously, we know John Emery. We know John Emery's story. We know what he's done when he's had the opportunity to play, and I think that's why we're all excited about potentially what can happen for that LSU running back room. Obviously, that LSU running back room added a player in Noah Cain from Penn State. Had a chance to see, I know he was on with Jordy. I think that was yesterday, so I know he's excited. Talked about being from Louisiana. He's going to add something, I think, a little bit different to this LSU running back room. When you're looking at Noah Cain Sets, who we all remember from recruiting. I mean, he was one of those names. Like, if it would have been the old school days, like with the Bayou Bash, he's had the big recruiting deal, and he didn't sign with LSU. It would have been one of those disappointing, just mad, everyone's wanting to get Noah Cain. You don't get him on campus, but he found his way to LSU. He's someone that at Penn State had 443 yards in his freshman year. In his sophomore year, remember, pandemic year, Penn State, and only played one game, and kind of the way that the Big Ten and Penn State, certainly their schedule played out, only had 13 yards because he only had three carries. In 2021, last year, definitely had his most carries, but the yards went down. He had 106 carries, goes down to 350 yards there, so only 3.3 yards per carry, had four touchdowns. Now, when you look at the freshman stats, they're popping. 5.3 a carry, had eight touchdowns, and this is someone that also added to the receiving game. Now, you come back and you look at 7.4 receiving his freshman year, only 6.1 in his junior year. So you're starting to try to find out what it is. And breaking down some of the tape, Penn State definitely had some offensive line issues. Penn State has been a team that I think if you looked up like who they've been, you would be surprised. I mean, they started out of the gate in 2020 just 0-5, and then you come back and you win your final four games, but they were a team that just was not a good football team a year ago. So Noah Cain, I guess he sees the writing on the wall, decides to come down to Baton Rouge, throw his hat in the ring for that LSU running back opportunity. Now, I will say this about John Emery. John Emery has worked his tail off to get back in position to be right for this LSU team, to be available for this LSU team. We all know what happened a year ago. Also, there was a ton of rumors about what was going to happen. They obviously were not true. We saw John Emery in the spring. We have seen flashes of what he can do. And when you look at his freshman stats, as I'm texting John Emery right now, by the way. Okay, he's going to try to join us in a little bit. That workout went a little bit longer, so we'll see if we can maybe break a little bit early and get to him. But anyways, you look at his freshman, I mean, we all saw it pop. I mean, first play that we saw from him, I believe Mario was against Georgia Southern. You probably would know. You're probably calling the game.
Yes, the juke. It was awesome.
It's like, okay, that's what we've been waiting on. We saw this at Destrehan in high school. And then the next year into 2020, we saw some more of the same. Like when he had an opportunity, he flashed. We remember the stretch run against Alabama where he takes it to the house. He goes – you know, 73 yards to the house, and we saw him be so explosive in very, you know, small amounts, a small sample size, because when you look at his carries, 39 in 2019, he had 75 in 2020, so only 114 total, but he's averaged over 5 yards a carry. He's somebody that also can help you in the receiving game, averaging 7 yards a catch, or right at 7 yards a catch, and so this is someone that LSU is going to count on. He might be one of the most important position players for LSU. I know there's some receivers that we can talk about. I know Kayshon, and you got to have him. That is critical. But when you look at the receiver room, it's deep. I mean, it is deep with three E's in the middle. You've got Jimmys and Joes there. Kayshon's the best. Do not get me wrong. But you have guys there that can step up. This running back room is very intriguing because you think you have some stuff. You think you have some juice. Armani Goodwin's someone that when he's been healthy, there's been a lot to like there. But getting him healthy for a full season, that's the key. Noah Kane, you never know, right? Freshman year, flashed. Sophomore year, wasn't able to play. Junior year, came back. The numbers dipped a little bit. Okay, again, watch the tape. The offensive line for Penn State struggled. But what can he do? Can he rejuvenize what he had his freshman year at Penn State? We know he's talented. Can he gain some of that? That's a question mark. You got Josh Williams as well, who earned a scholarship. He's had some moments. He's had some nice runs. How much can he help you? You lose Corey Kiner to the transfer portal. Right? We all know that. He's at Cincinnati now, so you're down a body there. John Emery's going to be crucial. It's going to be crucial if you can have the bell cow. Now, you don't have to have someone like Clyde Edwards-Helaire, who played 93% of the snaps in 2019. That's actually an outlier for LSU running backs. Every great LSU football team outside of that year had a running back by committee. You look at 2003, you had JV, you had Joe Addai, you had Chiron Carey, you had Allie Broussard. You look at 07. You had me, Richard Dixon, you had Trenton Holiday, Keelan Williams, Charles Scott. You look at 11 with all the stable of running backs they had in that national championship appearance. 2019 was outliner. So it can't be by committee, but I think you want to have that one guy. He might get 65, he might get 70% of the carries, but you know he's the guy. When times are tough, when there is a close play, he's in there. When the team runs out for the first play of the game, he's in there. So I think that's somebody that you definitely want to have. We'll see if we can get John. He's still trying to text me right now, trying to get out of the building to get some service. But you want to have that guy. You want to have that guy that you know you can count on. He's always there for you, even if it is a running back by committee. Now, sometimes that guy can change within a season. You look at 03. I mean, I think that definitely changed. Like, by the end of that year, JV certainly finished where he didn't start. I mean, he was finishing one of the best players in the country. So it can change, but I still think you want to have that guy. I think John Emery is that guy. Excited to see him on the field in this upcoming season. So here's what let's do this. Let's first tell you about AgTemp and AgTempVR.com. Service to the highest degree. Go to the website today. Mario, were you smart enough? Did you make the call? Did they come out and help you?
Yes, my AC is good now. My house is a reasonable temperature.
All right, there you go. That's thanks to AgTemp and AgTempVR.com. Get that set up today. And also, when we come back, because we're going to take a little bit of a shorter break, we'll do some Ask the Bench if we're not able to get John. John's trying to get on the phone right now, so we'll go ahead and we'll cut a little bit early. And while we're at it, while we're talking, let's go ahead and tell you about DraftKings. Download that app today in the App Store. It's something we've been telling you about over the last couple of days. So many different things. Like, it was hockey, but now you've got the opportunity, if you use promo code Baton Rouge, bet $5 on any UFC 276 fighter to win. God, 276. And get $100 in free bets no matter what. That's code Baton Rouge this Saturday at DraftKings Sportsbook, the official sports betting partner of UFC.
Remember, you got to be 21 or older, physically present in Louisiana. Availability varies by parish. Eligibility restrictions apply. Minimum $5 deposit. See DraftKings.com/sportsbook for full terms and conditions. Licensee partner, Golden Nugget Lake Charles. Gambling problem? Call 1-877-770-STOP. 7867.
Inside the chat, Jake casually slipping his name in there. Oh, that was part of the rotation. I mean, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't want to leave myself out.
Nah.
Look, I was a leading rusher on that team.
Got to. Oh, only
didn't, like, leave myself out.
I could
it
say.
Felt, it did feel awkward. I'll give it to you that. I didn't know how to say it.
Hester only cares about himself. We knew this.
Wow. Danny, of all, can you believe this? Of all, I'm surprised Mario would be like, yeah, in 2007, I actually wasn't on the official call, but what I did in the stands, I called it into my cell phone. I played it back on MySpace, and it was really big at the time.
Yeah, of all people, yeah. Mario, you should not be.
I mean, what? I wasn't trying to do that. I mean, just the facts are facts. All right, we'll see if we can track down John Emery. We'll see if we can get him on. Hopefully we can. If not, go ahead and get those Ask the Bench questions in. We'll have a much longer segment than we typically have there at the end to finish up the show.
OTB. OT.
All right, go to golfsuites.com. Golfsuites.com. As T-Bob told you, man, he went out there last Friday, and he had an absolute banger of a time. And there's so many different ways that you can have fun. And the hours always change. And so, like, it just depends on what you're looking for. Like, today they're open 11 a.m. until 12 a.m. Tomorrow they're open 11 a.m. until 1 a.m., right? So if you want to take the family, if you want to give some lessons to the kiddos, like, you can do that. But also, like, if you want to go out with the fellas, if you want to go out with the ladies, like, if whatever you want to do, like, whatever you're looking to get into, they can help you out there at Golf Suites. It can be whatever time you want it to be. So go out there, go check. If you want lessons, I mean, they can give you lessons there. You can play all the courses that you've dreamed of playing right there. They have the latest technology. It's highly convenient. It's right there off of Segan Lane. When you drive by it, you're going to have FOMO because you're going to want to pull in. You're going to have that experience over at Golf Suites. You can find out more information, golfsuites.com/LA.
In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
Three people walk into a bar. The first to order the same old marks. The third, Nuevo Topo Chico Margarita Hard Seltzer. Crafted with real lime juice and a crisp tequila flavor. Topo Chico Margarita Hard Seltzer.
Join 100.7 The Tiger and Our Lady of the Lake Ascension Saturday, June 25th at the Lamar Dixon Expo Center in Gonzales.
Enjoy live music from Tet Dur, Mike Broussard and the Night Train, and Jamie Badron and the Kickin' Cajuns. Make sure you grab a delicious plate of jambalaya from the Mike Ward's Liberty Safe's Jambalaya Cook-Off to raise money for the Alzheimer's services of the capital area.
The Swamp Pop Music Festival with Supreme Chevrolet.
Louisiana's Country Station.
100.7 The Tiger.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
Poor boy raised amid turn-of-the-century New Orleans, Louis Armstrong became one of the most recognizable people on Earth. Visit dropbiscuit.com today and check out the trailer to our first original series, Pops, The Louis Armstrong Story, starring Reno Wilson. Subscribe today.
Thank you.
OTB OT with Hester and T-Bob on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge and 94.7 ESPN Alexandria.
All right, welcome back in. Off the bench. Still trying to connect with John Emery there. I don't know. We'll see. I mean, we'll see if it happens. Hopefully, maybe. We'll see. But before we get to that, remember to drink Cold Coors Light, Busy Heart Seltzer, Blue Moon, Light Sky, Citrus Sweet. Let's go ahead and get some Ask the Bench questions in. And if John does, in fact, answer or call back, we'll have that for you there. Ask the Bench, who will have a better season, LSU football or the Saints? Good question. And it's a question that feels pretty similar in the fact that it's similar because it feels like both are kind of being slept on. Both have really nice pieces on their roster that people seem to not give credit for. I guess it depends on what you would consider successful. Like, is 8-4, 9-3, is that successful for the LSU Tigers? If it is, then yeah, I think you're going to have that. But if you're asking me this question right now in June, which you are, I think I'll say the Saints, because I think the Saints make the postseason. I think they make the postseason, and then once you get in the tournament, anything's possible. We've all seen that before.
Both teams have first-year head coaches, but the Saints have a much more complete roster, and they've had a lot of success against a team that's won the division the last couple years. So, yeah, give me the Saints.
I know what Danny's saying.
I'm going to Saints. A lot of people continue to sleep on the Saints' defense,
yeah,
even though they've been elite, like top three defense in the league.
Look, man, I was low on the Saints, and then they got Olave and Landry, and now I'm not as low on the Saints. It's that simple for me.
Yeah. We had the audio. We know.
And if Jameis stayed healthy last season, I think they definitely would have made the playoffs.
Made the playoffs. Maybe not made a run, but yeah. I agree. I think they would have made the playoffs. I mean, they almost did with Trevor Siemian.
Yeah.
No disrespect to T-Dot. But
that shows you how good of a roster they have.
Yeah.
Ask the bench, because me and Musso kind of debate this a lot on our show. If Jameis Winston is throwing for a lot of yards, is that a good thing or a bad thing? Because we've talked a lot about the prop, leading the NFL in passing
and last
yards.
Year he was successful while doing it a different way.
Exactly. And when he did have a high volume, he was throwing a lot of picks. So Jameis Winston getting a lot of yards, not necessarily a good thing for the Saints.
So it's going to be a little different here because we don't know the status of Alvin Kamara to begin the season. Right? So his status, I think, is going to greatly change the way that the offense is ran. If he's out, then you're talking about having, you know, Mark Ingram and one of the younger running backs, and I think the offense just changes a little bit. Jameis might have to do more. So we'll have to find out. Like, that question's hard to answer, I think, right now.
Yeah, we'll see what happens with Kamara. Apparently nobody knows what the heck is going on there. I know they had the hearing in August, and then maybe we'll learn more.
All right, let's see. Ask the Bench, realistic expectations for the Elvis movie. That comes from our guy, Daniel. Daniel, I'll be real honest with you. Like, I've seen a lot of bad Elvis movies. Obviously, like, impersonations. Like, he's going to have those in Vegas all the time. There's not many people that have gotten it right. Jonathan Rhys Meyers did really good, like, a TV special. Like, it's like a miniseries that came out, like, 20 years ago. Like, he did really well in that. But, like, I've been waiting for an Elvis biopic movie for 37 years, and like, we finally got. So my expectations are kind of mid right now, although like, my bar is set pretty high of what it needs to be. Like, I've been waiting for a long time. They've been making this movie, it's been in the works for a long time as well. It's been in the works for like 6 years or something like that. So they've had an idea of what they've wanted to do. So I'm going in with my expectations kind of just not too high, not too low, but my standard is going to be pretty damn high. And I hope they knock it out of the park. We'll see. Obviously, I mean, for y'all, that's going to be different. Like, y'all have been waiting for this your whole life, so y'all are just hoping it's a good movie.
I'm still going to watch it.
I'm interested to see how Austin Butler plays. I haven't seen much of his work, so.
Yeah, and as much as he put into the performance and the work and staying in character and keeping the accent the entire time that he's not only worked, but like in the press tour, kind of having it as well.
Yeah, Christian Bale did this same thing when he first did the first Batman, and I think also the second one. He kept the American accent because he's actually British, and he did it because he wanted to make people believe that the Batman character is American. So
yeah.
I mean,
he did it. Daniel Day-Lewis is notorious for doing that. I mean, staying in character to be able to I couldn't do it. I mean, even when I try to do like radio voice for like a 30-second commercial, like my redneckness wants to come out like really, really quick. So congratulations to them.
It's really funny to me hearing people with other accents try to do like American accents. Barstool Sports posted a video recently of some British people doing an American accent. I know Danny saw it. It was hilarious.
Oh, my English is so bad. It's so, so bad. I mean, I've tried. I had to do a video for the Premier League one time, NBC Sports, and it was Rebecca Lowe's. Was it her birthday? I'm gonna remember her birthday or like her 100th show or something. It was something honoring her, and we had to like do our best Rebecca Lowe. And I was like, dude, this is so bad. This is so, so bad. And the country's gonna see this, and this is not great. It was it's not great.
They saw it.
Yeah, I mean, they played on NBC. Not great.
They like fullbacks over there.
Just different fullbacks. Yeah. You're right, though. Ask the bench. Have you ever had Detroit style pizza? And do you like it? Y'all know Detroit style square, rectangle, actually.
It's good. I had it at Reginelli's the other day, and it was good. Usually, I don't like that much sauce, and the sauce is on top of the pizza in this case, but I was pleasantly surprised.
All pizzas, excellent.
Is it pizza, though? Is Detroit style, like, is it, do you consider that pizza?
I mean, consider it pizza.
It's almost like a damn casserole. I mean, it's so thick. Point. It's good. No, do not get me wrong. It's very
Chicago
good.
Chicago deep dish pizza?
Not really.
Not really. I told T-Bot the same thing. I don't think.
I mean, it's good. It's delicious. I love it. But no, I don't really. I consider it more almost like a lasagna or something.
Might do pizza for the draft tonight now.
Oh, look at you. We changed your mind. Ask the bench between rooting for the Hogs or Mike Bianco. Isn't the ex-LSU catcher and father of Drew the lesser of two evils?
I don't know, man. After a lot of opinions that LSU fans had about Bianco when he was somewhat in consideration to be LSU's coach, I guess, I think a lot of people will be taking an L if Ole Miss wins.
I don't know. I love Drew Bianco. Love his heart. Love the way he plays baseball. Saw him in the crowd last night cheering on his pops, as he should, by the way. Like, you can't hate on that. I've never been in the crowd of cheer for the SEC. It's just, y'all know me. Like, if I'm cheering for someone, how does it affect LSU always comes to mind. So, like, right now, I think of the three teams, like, if Oklahoma won, that affects LSU the least. And so, like, that's kind of where my mind always
definitely
goes.
Definitely best case scenario for most people, I think.
Yeah.
Boomer Sooner.
Hell yeah.
Okay,
I'm joking.
No, I'm with you. I'm with you there. Ask the bench, what will Moscone and T-Bob do together in New York? So, I guess they're both in New York?
Don't ask not Moscone.
I didn't know that.
They are like, wow. Wow. That plays.
They might go to a couple of dinners together, bookstores, hold hands.
Hold hands.
Greg says, Jacob, you are breaking my heart. Oh, no, man. I don't know what that – I'm not sure what breaking your heart. The director doesn't consider the Elvis movie a biopic. Yeah, I've heard that as well. I've heard more about, like, the times and, like, what was going on during that time. But it does have, obviously, some biopic to it. All right, that's going to do it for today. Join us tomorrow. We will be back. Rivers, who will be in studio? We'll have a tier list, shenanigans, the whole deal. We'll see you then.
OTB. OT.
All right, go to GoTrosOutdoorPower.com. GoTrosOutdoorPower.com. Remember, anywhere, and that is anywhere, corner to corner, 318-225-985-504-337. I think I got you all covered. If you're in one of those area codes, that means you live in the state of Louisiana, and that means they will deliver that Hustler zero-turn mower to your doorstep. That is something that they offer over at GoTro. So you go online right now, GoTrosOutdoorPower.com. You go to inventory. Once you do, first one pulls up, of course, Hustler. You click on it. It's going to pull up everything that they have available because they are Louisiana's number one Hustler dealer. And you're going to find something residential, commercial, again, to your doorstep, which is a great service. Also check out the power equipment and check out the pressure washers, generators, all that they have available from Hustler as well. Two locations locally, Baton Rouge and Gonzales. You can check out the showroom, but always go online, GoTrosOutdoorPower.com, where we make it easy.
Come on over to Corvell Toyota to pre-order your next vehicle, and you'll never pay over MSRP. Browse, reserve, pick up, and enjoy. It's that simple. So come on down to Happy Town. That's Corvell Toyota in Opelousas, Happy Town, USA.
Join 100.7 The Tiger and Our Lady of the Lake Ascension Saturday, June 25th at the Lamar Dixon Expo Center in Gonzales.
Enjoy live music from Ted Durr, Mike Broussard and the Night Train, and Jamie Badron and the Kickin' Cajuns. Make sure you grab a delicious plate of jambalaya from the Mike Ward's Liberty Safe's Jambalaya Cook-Off to raise money for the Alzheimer's services of the capital area.
The Swamp Pop Music Festival with Supreme Chevrolet.
Louisiana's Country Station.
100.7 The Tiger.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who were born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
This isn't just another day, it's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.